What's up, everybody? Welcome to Monday Night on Hyper RPG. It's time for Vanquished. I'm your overlord, which still sounds stupid to say out loud. let's go ahead and introduce our players on the show.
Hi, my name is AJ. I'll be playing Cross, your detective.
I am Liz, and I'm playing Olivia.
I'm Scott. I am playing Alara of Nebraska.
I'm Tara, and I'm playing Irida.
Remember when I was like, hey, guys, you should tell people what you do.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Like, you know, you are people that exist outside of this.
I'm playing Alara of Nebraska. That's what I do. No, you're not. Oh.
Because AJ's doing something really cool right now that you guys should know about, as well as everyone else, but...
Oh, yes. I'm a programmer over at Harebrained Schemes. We're making a new game called Necropolis.
Ooh.
A Diabolical Dungeon Delve. It's coming out. It's coming out, actually, in less than 2 weeks, on July 12th. Please, if you guys like roguelikes or if you like Dark Souls, tough games, one life, give it a try. It's a lot of fun. I'm super excited to see you guys play it. And you can see it here on Hyper RPG.
Yeah, that's right. July 9th, coming up next Saturday, we are going to be having a 12-hour long co-op death jam. We're calling with influencers from all over the country coming in, and we're booking flights for some pretty awesome people right now, but I don't want to tell you who they are until those flights are... booked. I don't want to be that guy that's like, so-and-so's gonna be here, and then they don't get their flight and it doesn't happen, and then I'll feel like an asshole. But the people we have locked are really amazing. So Liz, what do you do?
I am a software producer and I use Twitter a lot. That's me.
You can see me on Rabbit Stew on Wednesdays right here on Hyper RPG every Wednesday at 1, along with Zach. We talk about comic books and we recap this show. I can also be found on BJ's Geek Nation, a podcast that can be found at bjgeeknation.com.
I do community and marketing for King Games, and I'm on the board of directors for Geek Girl Con. If you haven't heard about Geek Girl Con, you should check it out.
You're awesome.
Check it out.
There you
We're
go.
Really
so,
awesome.
Thank you, guys. So, Roslyn is unfortunately unable to make it this week. She was on a shoot again today, but she's going to try to make it by the end of the show, so stick around. Chances are she will be here by the end, so stick around for that. Now, a couple quick announcements about our giveaways during this show. Like any show on Hyper RPG, every 5 subscribers, we give away a Steam key, which I think we have a couple copies of Gang Beasts to give away.
Ooh.
That we were just playing on the channel, and lots of other stuff too. So every 5 subscribers, we do a Steam key, and subscribers mean so much to us here on this channel. We're currently working on fulfilling our 1K sub goals. Yeah,
we did. And bicycle.
Okay, it's a thing. We have stuff to do now.
Question,
yes.
Do you have insurance just in case, you know, Claudia falls over?
I'm driving.
You mean Claudia? You mean Claudia steers them into a cliff when she is driving?
I'm driving. And on that note, we have some giveaways as well on this show. So on the show, you guys have probably seen every week that we have guest NPCs show up in the world, and these NPCs are people who won the week before. So far, we've had Reaper Xfish, we've had Geek 40. We had DTD Merrick, and
Super
this
villain.
Week, keep an eye out for Galushi, who was last week's winner. And to be a part of that, if we get up to $500 raised during the show, now, how that happens is at the top of our screen and on the side on certain windows and stuff like that, you are able to donate money to the channel that helps us keep the channel alive and well while interacting with the show by rewarding us with plot points. Now, plot points in this world allow for things like crazy shit to happen. So technically in the Bound Universe... Thank you for that.
Why, White Rabbit?
Was it?
Did the hashtag lead narrator remember to turn off alert sounds? Hashtag body drive.
Oh,
that was
awesome.
Is it too early to vote for MVP because White Rabbit?
Yeah, that's
won.
White Rabbit just won MVP.
Yeah.
White Rabbit's getting the event point at the end of tonight.
Was that White Rabbit?
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, that was definitely White Rabbit. And White Rabbit, that's Joe's job. I'm in front of the camera right now. But anyway, guys, that is basically how that works. Let me explain how plot points work. Plot points are something that exists in this world that I am the lead narrator on this show, which is like a GM, but also a little bit different. There's a little bit more storytelling in this world. And a plot point allows them to take over the story and say, this is what happens. Now, that doesn't just naturally mean it succeeds. I still have some authority on that to say whether or not it just succeeds, or if it could possibly succeed and give a buff to their roll and still have them roll for it as well, but the chances of it succeeding are extremely high. Now, we wanted to open this up for everyone to be able to participate, so all of your donations as low as $5 actually go towards the goal that they're making. All you have to do is hashtag their name, which you will see on the screen with the hashtag markers. When you're making your donation, use that hashtag like William T.W. just did.
Wow, thank you.
Yep.
A little plotting across the board from hashtag Neonet. Good luck all. Hashtag Cross, hashtag Livia, hashtag Nebraska, hashtag Arita, hashtag MCs, hashtag lead narrator.
Thank you so much, William TW. So that's how it works. You do the hashtag and the name and it will divide it up on the board. And yeah, it just divided up $2.4 for Cross, $2.4 for Livia, $2.4 for Nebraska, and $2.4 for Arita and myself. So that's how that works. So thank you guys so much for participating in that. Now, if we get up to $500 raised by the end of the show, we will give away this amazing limited edition Valiant Universe role-playing game book. These are very limited and we will all sign it on the cast. We will also throw in Transcendence Edge, the expansion for this, Ninjak Volume 1, and Harbinger Deluxe Edition Number 1, which is really heavy, and I'm gonna put it back down. It's really heavy. And we have a ton of other books to give away, as well as more role-playing game guide books if we get another 500. So every 500, we give away another NPC role and another book and a lot of other stuff. So we'll just keep, I mean, if we raised as much as like 2K in one night, we would give away 4 NPCs and I would freak out.
Why did you say out loud?
It'd be,
and you know, a busy week next week. You can make requests about your NPC too in order to, I don't know. Like,
no, how about no? Let's not bring that up.
Like tonight you will see Galusha's performance will be affected by our wonderful Galusha's suggestions.
Now, sometimes people, when they win that NPC, they go, I want my character to be like this. I'm like, fuck yourself. And then I do it anyway. So we'll see about that. So that was a quick update on how plot points work. Now, anything else that I should tell you guys about the universe really quickly? Yeah, why don't I do that? So basically in this universe, it's a little different than things like Dungeons and Dragons and stuff like that, where I am the lead narrator and we are telling a story as a group. It's more improvisational storytelling than it is crawling through a dungeon. Now, there are things that are very similar to other role-playing games in that it is still a game. We will still roll for things, but ultimately it's about having fun. It's very hard to rules lawyer this, even though people will try, because the rules state very clearly, if you don't know, make it up. It's about having fun with your players and coming up with a really cool and creative story. Now, they do have to roll for certain things. They have certain classes and stats like might, intellect, charisma, and action. And if you are reading the book, you'll see that action is kind of defined as something you use in combat, but we're going to be using it on our show as dexterity as well, since there isn't really a stat for dexterity, and that makes sense. It's in the word. We'll use it for that. So those are the things they'll be rolling for. You'll see some of them have stats that are fairly high in a certain area, like Arita with her intellect, and low in other areas like Alara of Nebraska with his intellect. So, and then everyone also has luck. Now, luck is a number that they had to pre-design to a certain number that can be applied to any two dice that they're rolling, except when they're rolling a power die with a d12, then it's only the d12. And it doesn't apply to your power die unless you're only rolling your power die. And it changes every other week or so whenever I relook at the rules and try to figure out what in the hell they're saying in there. But that's how we've interpreted it, so that's what we're doing. Wild Bronco 38 just subscribed, guys!
Oh, thank you!
Thank you for that. And we also just had a couple more donations come in. Thank you, DT Merrick, Eternal Knight 001. Thank you both for that. Are you guys ready? Are you ready to do this, man?
Let's go.
Let's do this.
I'm like, do we have any other announcements? Oh! Actually, we do. We will not have a show next Monday because it is 4th of July in the United States, and I can't in good conscience ask my employees to come in and work on that day, except that I did already ask Emily and Ryan to come in and work that day. But we will be working on the studio and getting ready for the Necropolis event and doing tests and all that kind of stuff. But all of the hosts and everybody will have 4th of July off next week, so you're welcome, but sorry. Like, you're welcome, guys. Have fun. 4th of July. Redneck Christmas. It's actually the first time I haven't gone home for 4th of July in years, because it is Redneck Christmas, and we treat it as such.
Nice.
So, anyway, guys, are we ready to get this show rolling?
Let's do it. Yeah.
We got a long prologue tonight, huh? Loosen up. All right. Welcome, everyone, to Volume 1, Issue 4 of Vanquished, The Awakening. 7 days ago, five strangers met outside a razor wire fence strung along an abandoned hospital in rural Idaho. A hospital that had seemingly been destroyed in an act of terrorism 2 years prior. Only one of them, Erida, had arrived of her own free will. The others had been drawn to the hospital subconsciously, and without hesitation, their curiosity led them inside, revealing a laboratory filled with strange testing equipment. Before anything valuable could be obtained by the infiltration, PRS agents stormed the building. In their escape, they discovered that they had remarkable powers that had somehow been hidden within them. Were these abilities always present, or was it exposure to the hospital that awoke them? Unsure of how to proceed, Miss Eve suggested to the group that they take the zip drive that they had found at the facility to Octavio Gonzalez, also known as Axe, hoping that there might be some answers hidden underneath all the pornography. They were able to escape Idaho in Eve's private jet, but not without drawing unneeded attention with the murder of a police officer along the way. When the group presented the drive to Axe, he reacted in a way that hinted they had in fact had gone through something like this before, possibly. He wiped the drive clean of any data and issued a warning to Eves to just forget about it and move on. PRS agents had followed them to LA and ambushed the facility, kidnapping Axe, Eves, and Petunia. A bloody battle broke out with a PRS officer, and the group barely made it out alive, leaving the building to crumble behind them. Luckily, they were able to meld into the local homeless population, giving them some breathing room from the authoritative figures. They no longer felt a pull to stay together like before. Something that was there just seemed to be missing. So they decided their best hope for answers about everything that had led them to this point was to stick together and rescue Eves and Petunia. Cross, being as resourceful as he is, had an old police academy contact he thought they might be able to use to dig up some info on PRS. Though Merrick seemed interested in helping them at first, upon learning of their abilities, things took a quick and sudden turn for the worse. The group left Merrick lying on the floor bleeding, missing his left hand, inadvertently probably creating their first supervillain.
Yeah, about that.
My bad.
I honestly cannot wait to come back to that. Someday, it's gonna be really, really great. They left the Wiltern Theater, making their way down to the subway, exiting off Alvarado, blending back into the homeless population while they devised a plan. They decided they needed to get out of LA and fast. Left with few options, Cross had a contact run plates on cars left in alleyways to see what might be left uninsured. He was taking a chance that an uninsured car might belong to an illegal immigrant that would somewhat go unreported if stolen. It's a pretty low move there, buddy.
Thanks.
He grabbed a white minivan filled with children's toys, and along with the rest of the group, headed east.
I'm gonna just retire now.
You're cold, man. Nearly crippled with exhaustion, confusion, and guilt, everyone slept, except for Cross. Something deep inside him seemed to push him forward. He drove for 12 hours, and they slept. At a diner outside of Albuquerque, they noticed a television broadcast. Authorities have reason to believe the apartment building collapse in downtown LA yesterday was an act of terrorism. A terrorist attack presumably by the same individuals who had attacked the Mountain Home, Idaho hospital in March of 2014. Officials ask that you notify your local police department if any of these three individuals, known to still be at large, are seen. The TV showed images of Cross, Alara, and Livia, all wearing white coveralls, taken at a time that none of them had any memory of. They realized that PRS may not know of Erida's involvement and decided to head to her grandfather, Carlisle's house in Guffey, Colorado. They've been held up in Guffey for 3 days now. Still unable to make sense of what all has taken place, they've for the most part been catatonic. Cross and Livia have set up a shooting range to experiment with their powers. Nebraska has found some comfort tending to Carlisle's vegetable patch. And Erida has layered the kitchen table with books, newspaper clippings, and records, all detailing accounts of PRS activity over the last 20 years, searching for anything that might help in the hunt for Eves and Petunia. Erida?
Hey, Grandpa.
Morning.
Morning. Is it morning? Apparently it's morning. Hi.
You've been up all night again, I see.
I got lost in my reading.
Coffee?
That'd be wonderful, thank you.
Yeah. Find anything?
No. I keep looking over the same things over and over, trying to figure out where they could have taken this Eves and Axe, and I have no idea where to look next.
This Eves, she's like the rest of you?
I think so. I don't know exactly what her power is, but everything leads me to believe that, yes. She's the one that I found the video of her at the hospital. So I recognized her right away when we all met up. But I don't know any more about. She can sure throw a mean punch though. But other than that, I'm not really sure.
It's a weird group you've got yourself mixed up in.
Yeah, Grandpa, thanks for letting us come here again. I didn't know where to turn.
It's all right. I mean, you're welcome to stay here as long as you need. Just, you know, you probably shouldn't stay here long, what with, you know, the news and all. And
I mean, good thing is they haven't recognized me or know that I'm with them. So, I mean, we're safe in that regard.
But you know how these small towns work.
I know, somebody's gonna show up like Billy from down the street to get extra potatoes, and you're always so nice, and you always give him the extra potatoes.
Billy moved out years ago.
Oh, I haven't been here in a while.
I remember him, he... sweet boy.
Yeah.
That Cross fella, did he really kill a police officer?
It wasn't him per se. It's the other side of him that's part of, I guess you could say, his power. It's a different person, I guess you could say. Different personality. Detective Cross is a very nice man. He has a good heart. I can't really speak so much about the same about the blue man.
Well, you reminded him that your grandpappy has a shotgun under the bed, right?
Absolutely, Grandpa.
He'd be real stupid to try anything fishy around
Grandpa,
here.
I don't think you have to worry about that.
All right.
He doesn't even like guns.
Now that other boy, the Nebraska boy.
Yes.
You sweet on him?
No. Grandpa, I know you always wanted me to be with a farmer, and it's really nice that he's helping you.
Oh no, he's dumb as a box of rocks. I'm just curious if, you know, I know what it's like. I was in the war. I know what it's like to go through intense, stressful situations with people.
Grandpa,
and
I'm not that kind of lady, you know?
The upstairs bedroom's been empty for a long
time. Oh my gosh, Grandpa! Grandpa!
Some action went down.
Grandpa!
In this house.
Grandpa!
Alright,
oh,
fine.
Oh my
fine,
gosh,
fine.
How's the coffee coming? I could really use some of that right about
I
now.
I set it down in front of you.
Oh, is that? Oh. It's been a long night. Did I say that already?
Yeah. It's okay, you're flustered, I understand. It's cute, you got a crush. It's
oh my god. Grandpa, I do not have a crush. Anyways, we don't need to talk about it, it's fine.
Okay.
Very nice,
What can I do to help? What can I do to help? I'm here for you, sweetie. What can I do?
You know, I really need to... If you could help... I don't even know where to start, Grandpa. Like, I've been looking at these files and everything I can find online. I mean, it's not like there are books on PRS. You can't really check that out from the library.
Yeah.
I mean,
they've been showing up in the news a lot lately, though, and...
But there's no information about, like, their headquarters or who's involved. There are no names. I'm not even sure, like, how they recruit people.
You figure as a private military company, these things would be available to the public, you know? That you could just look them up in a phone book, you know? Like, back in the good old days, but now everything's secret and in the... I don't understand it. But it doesn't make sense to me that in this country we can have entire military groups just running around all willy-nilly and shit, just doing whatever they wanted.
I know, Grandpa. You know, like, I don't think they make phone books anymore, by the way.
They still make phone books.
I don't know if they do.
I get one every 6 months.
You get a phone book still?
Yes!
We never got those at the library. That's interesting. Okay.
Kids and your privileges these days.
Do you want me to check the phone book? Is that what you're suggesting?
No. Maybe old, but I'm not stupid.
I didn't say that, I was just being...
Listen, honey, listen. If you need anything, any help going through whatever it is you're looking for, I've got all day, I could definitely help.
That would be amazing. Maybe you could help me organize where all these events are happening so I can try to figure out if there's some kind of pattern.
All right, well, you mind if I put on some tunes?
Sure, Grandpa, of course, this is your house.
MTV Top 20 has been really good this week.
Oh, well, okay.
So Erida and Grandpa Carlisle, surprisingly find music on MTV and get to work, and we head outside to Detective Cross and Livia, who have set up on a couple fence posts coffee cans about 10 feet away, 20 feet away, 30 feet away, out in the tall grass woods that surround the backside of Carlisle's house.
Okay, so I'm just gonna try to move the closer one. Like, I mean, this should work, right? This should completely work.
The street, like, have you ever shot a gun before?
No.
All right, focus on it, think of center mass, steady your focus on it, and expect where it's gonna land. And this, I don't know how that works, just push your energy to the...
You don't know how that works. That's really helpful, thanks.
Look, I can teach you with accuracy, I can't teach you how to poof or whatever you do.
I'm working with BAM.
Bam. All right, fine.
I don't know. Here we go. I saw it on TV once.
Ready?
Bam!
Oh, you're using a plot point? Okay, what happened?
Livia pushes her hands forward. The energy, as it always does, coalesces out of her hand, surges forward, and instead of hitting the nearby can, she hits the farther can, which vanishes. And somewhere else on the grounds of Grandpappy Carlisle's house, poor...
Okay, I see what you mean. On the west-facing side of the house, there is a garden with lots of vegetables and fresh fruit and herbs growing, and Alara of Nebraska has found himself tending to the vegetables, as it's something he's found quite the solace and peace in doing as he's traveled the country of the last 1.5 years tending to farms, minding his own business, as a can comes flying out of the air and slams into the front of his head. Can you go ahead and do a... Can you roll action for me?
Sean Harvey damned. What the hell was that?
12.
Go ahead and take one click of damage there.
This is a wonderful start.
I'm just gonna glare at them and go back to my farming.
Sorry! I didn't think that would work.
Hold up a second. Alright, see that one right there? Shoot it, that. Just bamf at it. Alright, ready?
Okay. Bam!
Man, I wonder if, Alara's like a natural farmer or something. Like, look at him, he's just a natural at it.
Okay. I don't understand where this is going.
I wait. Damn it. Okay.
Actually, I don't have any plot points up here. I'm gonna use a plot point on that one. And coming flying out of the air from the other direction, a can hits Nebraska on the other side of the head. Go ahead and roll an action for me.
I almost spit out my water.
12 again.
Nice, good rolling.
That's all right, I got luck, so. go ahead and take another click of damage off your armor there.
Oh, my eye!
Okay, that one was purely accidental.
You should have known with that grin on your face.
Okay, no, this is good. This is great, actually. All right, we're gonna try something new this time.
I think you're trying to get me in trouble.
Would I do that?
Yeah.
I would. But ignore him.
Ignoring?
All right, this time, aim all your focus on first the object which you want to bamf. But then immediately think about another location. Like, see that far can on the farther side? Think about the can disappearing and then landing on top of the other one.
Wow, this seems really, like, precise.
All right. Just listen to my voice. I'm gonna actually spend a plot point on this.
Oh, you're gonna use a plot? We're gonna spend all our plot points on training Livia.
Have you seen what happens when she doesn't hit
it's
her?
It's true, though.
It's true, we need to train her up.
We definitely, I would like to right. Stop vomiting by missing body parts.
All right. You're good at actually hitting a target, so just do that.
Okay, once more, power surges through Livia's arms, bam!
And the can disappears and comes falling down right on top of the other can.
That was so cool!
There we go.
Awesome.
Control is everything.
Sweet.
Just put your mind eye to your achievement and you can get anything done.
That was pretty, like, inspirational. I don't know, you're not half bad at this.
Well, I didn't always want to be a detective. I mean, I joined the force just to help people, honestly. Detective part kind of came with the politics of it.
Huh. Like, what kind of politics?
Look, when someone gets shot in line of duty, it doesn't really look good to the force. You either retire them, and if they can somehow come back, you don't leave a hero on the street just as a patrol officer. You do something with them, and I never had a good eye for being a commissioner or anything of that sort. Plus, I'm too young for that anyway, so. I know I would put, you know, one and one together, so they gave me a shot, and I passed the exam.
But you didn't like it?
Detectives tend to do things about murders, vice, the terrible side of the humanity. It's important. We need to police people, but we also need to look at their good side, too. I mean, as a patrol officer, you get to help people in day-to-day lives. I mean, that life's over now. Even if this all breaks through, I'm never gonna be a cop again. And
yeah. I don't really know what any of us are gonna do after this.
Yeah. I think it's first step is first. I don't want to even think about that. I mean, right now we gotta deal with the fact that you can teleport. I have a murderous psychic being. So whenever I black out, someone dies. So first things first is controlling our powers. That way no one else dies. Then we figure out, you know, how to get rid of them or at least finding out more.
Yeah. And find Reeves. Rhea. Reeves. Reeves.
Reeves. That's gonna be the hard part. I mean.
And Petunia.
And Petunia.
As Cross and Livia continue their conversation over by the makeshift shooting range that they've constructed, Nebraska, still reeling from the hit to the head twice from metal cans, notices across the field, through the tall grass on the other side of a fence, a middle-aged woman waving for his attention. Hello? You there?
Me.
Hello? Yes, you!
Me?
Yes!
Yep.
I need some help, do you mind?
I walk across the street.
Okay, just through the field, over the fence.
Oh, and through the walk field, towards her.
Through the grass.
Make a beeline.
You see as you walk up upon this woman that she's standing next to a small lawnmower whose gear mechanism has just kind of popped out and she's not strong enough to get it back in. If you don't mind, I'm really sorry to bother you. I saw that you just came in town with Erida and you look like a strong man and I'm here by myself and if you just don't mind popping this back into gear for me, that would be great.
How? You need assistance? You're friends with Lady Erida?
I doubt she remembers me. It's been a very long time.
Understandable.
I know her grandfather very well, yes.
So you know Grandpappy Carlisle?
Grandpappy, yeah, Carlisle. I know Carlisle, yes.
Yes. How may I assist you, madame?
Could you just pop this back into gear for me, please? I would really appreciate it. For the life of me, I can't do it. I could go get a pry bar, but seeing a strong man right across the field just seems like a much easier solution.
So how many pieces are lying on the ground?
Oh, that's not pieces, just a lawnmower. It's just the lawnmower that's there, and the gear mechanism has just kind of popped out of gear off to the right, and would just take someone really strong to pull it, if you understand it.
Yeah, I'm just gonna get down there and maybe just start, like, pushing things. I guess.
Dear, okay, just.
So I don't. I'm sorry. I don't know how this contraption works.
Oh. So you came from the city then?
No. I'm not from any city. I'm from Nebraska.
Oh. Okay. So she kind of gets up behind you and reaches around your arms, grabs your hands and puts them on the gear shift. And then the two of you together start jerking in this motion, knocking the gear shift into one jerk with you, and you realize what she's trying to do, easily pops it into gear.
Pop it into gear.
Thank you. That is all I needed. Thank you so much. I just needed a strong man around to help with some of the chores around the house.
You're quite welcome. I'm glad I could be of assistance.
You see that she's kind of eyeing you up. Would you like to come inside for some tea? Some iced tea, just for the help.
What? That sounds splendid!
Some sweet tea.
Some sweet tea would be lovely.
Great.
I don't think I've ever had tea before.
So the two of you walk into her small ranch-style house. She has a collection of pictures of kids along her wall who are obviously now grown and moved on with their lives. And she makes her way over to the refrigerator. You know, you seem extremely familiar. Have you come to visit Carlisle before?
No, I've never met Grandpappy Carlisle before.
Carlisle.
Grandpappy Carlisle, yes.
Carlisle. Oh, Pappy, fine. Pappy Carlisle. Yeah, that's, I'll let him know. Pappy Carlisle it is at the town meetings from here on out. Here's your...
Thank you. Grab it with my left hand. And I'm just gonna, how does the house look?
The house is laid out as you walk in. There's a very small living room with one recliner and a TV that's always on. And the kitchen is connected. And there's just a small L that leads around to the backside for a refrigerator with a door that leads out and a small hallway with one bedroom and a bathroom. Extremely small one bedroom house. So how long are you in town?
Oh, until we... I don't know. Lady Erida needs to find some answers, and then we'll move on.
Oh, doing a little soul searching? Are you two...
Are we...
What?
Together?
Together? All four of us are together.
There's four?
Well, there were five. We're trying to find our lost companion. And her dog.
You're from Nebraska, so pardon me if I sound frank. Are these friends or lovers?
These are my friends. None of them are lovers yet.
Your four friends, your companions. That's so cute. Companions that you've traveled with, and you're looking. You've lost someone and their dog. That's so sad.
Yes, our friend is missing. We must find her.
Oh, you poor thing.
Well, thank you.
Here, have some more tea.
Oh, thank you. It's very delicious.
Yeah.
Keep on just drinking that tea.
So the two of you keep having small talk, and we go back now to Carlisle and are looking through the papers. I mean, there. I commend you for your detailed research, and there's nothing here, honey. This is just public facing. You know, ever since 1996, when they sold the media to those fuckers.
Grandpa, these are respectable journalists.
You're not gonna find anything. Yeah, you're not gonna find anything in these. There's nothing in here. It's just an all smoke screen. Their name pops up every once in a while, but for what? Where are they? Who are they? What do they do? I guess this is your.
Your
frustration, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Welcome to my last couple nights.
You know, I know you and your daddy didn't get along very well, but it seems like a cruel twist of fate that even now, that bastard's presence is hanging over you.
Wait, what do you mean? Grandpa, what are you talking about?
Honey, you know, just stay right there. So, Carlisle makes his way out of the kitchen, walking upstairs. You hear some rummaging around and clanking and opening of doors, and you hear the sound of the attic stairway kind of thump, and the stairs come down. You hear him step up, moving around in the attic, comes back down, closes it. It's a very long, silent process. 10 minutes, just waiting for him to come back downstairs. That I would have pantomimed, but we don't have all night.
While I'm waiting, I fix all the papers that Grandpa's messed up because he doesn't understand my organization system. And so I rearrange things the way that they're supposed to be.
I'm coming down the stairs and I notice you doing that. Got that one from your mother, did you? Okay. So, I have here a box of your father's belongings.
I don't want anything from him.
I don't understand that.
Why would you even bring those down?
Well, honey, life's complicated, okay? And towards the end of his life, your father wasn't really worth much of anything, which...
Towards the end of his life?
No, he wasn't always like that.
Okay.
He was once as optimistic and hopeful as you. You know, you get that from him.
What?
You wouldn't know it.
No. But pretty sure I get that from you. I don't even know how you had somebody like him as a son, Grandpa. Like,
you need to understand.
I don't like talking about him.
You'll come to learn, extreme events have a way of changing people. Now, I don't expect to understand what you're going through right now and what you're... happened to you 5 years ago, I'm not even going to pretend to understand. But you need to at least understand your father went through some difficult times. And so he sets down the box in front of you, opens it up, and immediately on top there's an ID card that he pulls out, and it has your father's picture on it, next to it saying Project Rising Spirit. So, you know, with all that's happening here, it never seemed like it was something you needed to know before. And I didn't want to keep it from you now, but it seems like it's just going to throw you down a road that you're not these aren't the kind of people. Your father was messed up in some really nasty stuff, and I don't. I don't want you.
I think at this point, I don't know if I have to use a plot point for this.
Okay.
I'm not sure. So perhaps.
Better just use it for safety.
I'll use it just for safety. I'm not really I'm shocked and super confused and very upset and angry that he would kept this from me, especially considering I've talked to them about this before. And a cloud just forms around me and starts misting in the room.
No.
And I'm just stunned and I don't know what to do.
Honey, I'm gonna ask that you calm down. I know there's a lot to take in, but you have to understand, I have your best intentions at heart. You don't want to go putting your nose in these people's business. I know you've been thrown into it. And it's a fucked up world to put you there, and I'm sorry. I never wanted you to ever get mixed up in the things your father... He didn't either. He spent a lifetime shielding you from it. He wasn't there because he didn't want... for you to see what he had become.
I can't believe you didn't tell me this before. What am I supposed to do with this?
I need you to stop, honey. I just fixed the drywall on the ceiling just a couple months ago.
I'm sorry, Grandpa.
Just bring it together,
okay? I don't really know how to control this yet.
I don't have the kind of money lying around to just fix the ceiling every time you come over.
Okay, I'm just trying to stop. I don't know how to... Grandpa, I'm sorry. I don't know how to control
Carlisle
it yet.
Carlisle goes over to the door and just starts fanning. Now, honey.
Oh,
you'll find
Grandpa.
Inside that box...
How did you get this stuff to begin with?
PRS dropped off his belongings.
You've talked to them before?
Well, that was years ago, honey, when he...
How long ago?
When he passed. Some of this came from them. Like the picture here of you and your mother. Some of it we found in his apartment that he had in San Francisco that...
Did he ever tell you how he found them?
How he found...
PRS. How did this even happen?
Well, he was in the military, and when he got out, there wasn't much for people like him to do. Honey, you have to understand, the economy hasn't been good for a long time, and...
So he...
Men like him that get out of the military, there's not really a place for him in society, and...
Let's just go murder people. That sounds great.
Now, that's not what your father intended. He had a family to take care of.
Oh, he did a great job of that. I'm sorry, Grandpa. I'm sorry. It's hard to be positive all the time.
I understand, but just... Have a look. You might find some things of interest in here, and I'm sorry to have kept it from you, but...
No, I understand why you did.
Just be careful, okay? You've mixed up in some weird...
I know, the Grandpa...
Weird shit.
I promise, they're good people. Well, they need me around so they'll be good people. I know that they're good people deep.
Real deep.
Deep.
Real deep. Honey.
Down. I mean.
I'm pretty sure that Livia girl's cleared out the house of any alcohol. Like that.
Grandma, she saved my life. I might have been a mess and smelled really gross. And she kind of stole a lot of my clothes, but I mean,
well, that
she
explains
clothes.
Where your grandmother's jewelry went, but. Look, that may be deep down, but. And I know you have a big heart.
I need to stay with them. I mean, I feel like they're the only people that really under. I've never even met another person with powers, Grandpa. I've been hiding. You know I've been trying to hide this and get rid of it for 5 years. I've never even talked to somebody.
No getting rid of it.
You never know. You might be able to.
Look, it's a new world out there. Things are changing.
Well, they're the closest things I have to people, I have to friends. and I don't know, I like them in a weird, strange way. I know that sounds weird. They're not really my type of people I used to bring around from graduate school, but.
Okay, well, have a look through that box and go change your shirt. You're soaking wet.
Oh yeah, okay. Thanks.
And we go back now to the small house across the field.
All right.
So well,
I'm standing a little closer right
tell
now.
Me, tell me more about this loam. I've never heard of it. It sounds like such a strange, in Europe, possibly?
No, much, much farther than that. It's an interesting place. There's lots and lots of plant life.
So, I mean,
none of these, not as many buildings, no big cities, no I mean, you're, vehicles.
You're white as the Dickens, so I just figured it's some European, but this, South America, Africa,
no, it's
Brazil?
Not, no, no, none of, it's not on this world.
Help. Well, you are just a whole bundle of joy to unwrap here, aren't you?
You wish to unwrap my bundle of joy?
More sweet tea.
Oh, yes, please.
Are you sure we haven't met before?
No, I'm quite certain I would remember you.
Okay, well, pardon me, I have to. I'm gonna go put a couple more tea bags and some ice. So she makes her way over to the kitchen counter and starts filling the pitcher with kitchen ice. Now, for some reason, I feel like I know you, and I'm not just coming on to you by saying that. I seriously mean, I feel like I've seen you somewhere before. And she turns around with the pitcher filled with water and sees behind you, as you're sitting at the kitchen table, across from you, behind, over your shoulder on the TV screen, she sees a picture of you and Livia and Cross and drops the water and starts shaking.
Are you all right?
Don't hurt me.
Why would I hurt you? I take a step towards her.
Stay back! She reaches behind her and pulls a knife out of the drawer. It's a butter knife, but it's the closest thing that she can. Just stay back!
please, I'm not gonna hurt you.
You're a terrorist!
I have no desire to terrorize anybody.
You're on the news. You're the terrorist that's been on the news.
Hey, maybe that's how you recognize me!
What is wrong with you?
I don't trust me. This is all. I mean you and this world. I mean nobody any harm. I'm just looking for answers. My friends and I were just trying to find our friend.
They said you blew up a hospital.
And that
you killed a bunch of people in Los Angeles.
A bunch. I'm pretty certain I had nothing to do with the hospital.
As you're saying this, her phone starts to ring. It's a cell phone on the table right behind you and to the right. She looks down at it and tries to lunge for it. And in doing so, you turn and reveal your right arm as you grab it before she can.
All right. Instinctively grab the phone.
Yeah. What is on your arm?
Oh, this, I don't know. But trust me, it's fine. And I hand her the phone.
As you're holding the phone out, you can see that the phone starts sparking a little bit, and actually, like, the screen starts to flicker and sends out a high-pitched noise, and then and a little puff of smoke comes out of the top of it. Terrorist! Terrorist!
Listen.
You put a bomb in my phone!
I think, calm yourself. Calm your hysteria, woman. I will leave you now. I mean you no harm. Thank you for the tea. It was delicious. I don't. I'm sorry. I don't speak whatever language that is. I slowly start to back away, and just out of the house.
So Nebraska exits the house, leaving the woman
Cover my arm.
Cover your arm. And head back. You start to head back.
And I'm just gonna try at the very least to start farming and hope nobody noticed the screaming that I caused across the field.
Hold on.
What?
Okay, so I'm gonna say, luckily for you, this community is civilized enough to have gotten rid of their landline phones, and you've just destroyed her cell phone, which seems highly unlikely, but pretty low on that. I wouldn't
say. That didn't go well at all.
So Nebraska makes his way back across the field, hurrying a little bit with the sound of a screaming woman in the background. And as he runs back into the garden area, you guys see him hop the fence and start working quickly.
Well, I'm probably in the middle of... All right, we're trying to do some moving targets now. That's a lot harder.
Do
I'm going to throw up.
Do you see what I'm seeing?
What? What are you...
Nebraska.
Do I hear any screaming?
Hear something? Hey! How's the gardening going?
Wonderfully! Wonderfully! Everything's great over there. Everything's going very well. Thank you.
You're not, like... hungry or anything, right?
No. I'm fine. They're fine. We're all fine.
Why are you hitting a roll for lying?
No, I will say, go ahead and roll charisma.
Charisma, let's see how this works. Luck!
Oh. You guys just think that Nebraska is being his weird and unusual self.
Seems about right.
Would you like some potatoes?
What is it with this place and potatoes, by the way?
I thought that was Idaho.
They're nature's candy. They're filled with about every nutrient you could possibly need. In fact, the weird one with the long hair.
I'm Alara of Nebraska, Grandpappy Carlisle.
God, I hope my granddaughter's not into you. Stupid as all hell. Just bring about 10 potatoes in, all right?
Yes, Grandpappy Carlisle!
Carlisle makes his way back inside, where we find Erida rummaging through the box and all of its belongings.
Did he call you Grandpappy?
How close are you to me?
Why is he calling you Grandpappy? I have never.
Look, I'll stop
you
asking you questions if I can stop using my imagination. It's weirding me out. So, as you're going through the box, you notice a list of names with numbers and addresses on them, and a little black book.
Wait, one of these names looks... Have you looked through this, Grandpa?
You know, when I first was given that box, I may have peeked around a little bit, but then felt pretty creeped out. And
yeah,
felt a little weird and put it back up in the attic.
Do you remember who gave it to you? Do you remember who came by?
You know what? No, I can't remember who dropped it off. I do remember a couple names, though, in that box. I remember some names in that box as people, though. That's people we've...
Galushi?
Yeah, yes!
That's the
Joe.
One that's...
Joe Galushi.
Joe Galushi, because I keep going back to this one, and I don't know why I recognize
him. Well, you met him numerous times.
I met him?
Yes.
When?
He was your father's direct superior. There would have been numerous...
In the army?
No.
Oh.
In PRS.
Oh.
He... would come over for dinner from time to time with your father. I don't know what he probably told you and your mother he was doing or was, but he was your father's direct superior, and...
Yeah, I feel like I remember the name. It's cut... I can't put a face with it, though.
You'd remember him. He's an ugly Scottish prick. If you
ever
saw
the
one.
Scottish man! Oh! Huh. Yeah, he wasn't...
always had some weird pet names for you that kind of freaked us out and didn't like him being around the kids.
Yeah, I didn't care for him too much.
Always bringing you over candy and toy trains and stuff. I don't know what
I was like, old. Why are you bringing me toy trains? It was really weird.
Yeah, I mean, there were Ninja Turtles back then. He could have given you a Ninja Turtle or something like that. But
I already had all the Ninja Turtles.
Wooden trains and weird European doohickeys. I don't know.
I liked the candy, though. I remember liking the candy. But he was always just...
Take the candy. Sweetie, if a man offers you candy, I know I've given you this advice before, but if a man offers you candy,
really
you just
candy,
don't
Grandpa.
Take it. You know, I told you 22 years ago, when you took that candy from that man in the park, you don't take candy from strangers.
Nothing happened. What other names did you recognize from here? Because I'm not... None of the other ones are ringing a bell.
The years, sweetie, they start to blend together, but this Galushi fella, he lives not too far from here up in Walden.
He's in town?
Well, not town. He's across the mountain, but...
But he's in Colorado.
He's in Colorado, up in Walden.
Interesting. You haven't seen him since, though, him and Dad.
No. He was at the funeral. That was...
He went to Dad's funeral? Huh.
Yeah.
Huh. That's interesting.
Did he
say anything to you?
As they're continuing their conversation, the rest of you make your way inside with the potatoes and...
Potatoes, nature's candy, who wants them?
Stupid. Just put them on the... fill up a pot with...
Grandpa? Manners.
Very stupid. Do you mind putting water in a pot for me and setting it to boil?
Absolutely,
Grandpa. Nebraska, thank you so much for bringing in the potatoes.
Do you know where to get the water from, Nebraska?
Yeah, it's been a week. Lady Arata taught me 4 days ago.
Awesome.
See if you can figure out how to turn the stove on this time, you fucking idiot.
Grandpa!
Now, as I said, this... Galushi fella, he's up in northern Colorado, not too far from here, maybe 5-6 hours over the mountain.
Have you heard anything about him? Like, is he still a part of PRS, or?
No. I have no idea. I didn't necessarily think it'd be a good idea to keep sticking my face around those PRS people after your father died. Prefer not to be involved, and I shouldn't, you know, this is all making me really nervous and uncomfortable.
No, I know. I'm sorry, Grandpa. I'm sorry to draw you into this. I just didn't know where else to go, and...
You turn it to on! It's electric!
I'm trying. I'm sorry. Could I have some help, please?
I go over and help him.
Thank you, Lydia.
You're only enabling him.
I'm teaching him how to do it!
Could you teach me to?
Press in. And you turn the knob, but not too high. You don't want to, that's too high. See, this is the different temperatures.
Sir.
Hot, less hot.
I didn't mean to overhear, but I did hear something about a PRS agent.
She told you about the shotgun I have under my bed, right?
Grandpa.
No, she didn't, sir, but.
I don't mean that in any way, shape, or form to be a racist kind of.
Grandpa!
Kind of thing. I'm just, you said you have something deep inside you that.
I'm sorry, Detective.
She told me about the police officer you killed, and I completely trust you. If my granddaughter trusts you, I completely trust you, sir. But there is a shotgun under my bed, and I serve 2 terms in the United States military, and I'd like to remind you that if you try anything funny, I'll blow your goddamn brains out.
I appreciate that, sir.
Keep that weird thing you got inside you. Well, what was your question, son?
Well, first of all, thank you for your service, and...
Now, don't pander me. And what do you want?
Oh, I'm not pandering.
And don't get smart with me there. What do you need?
I heard you mentioning a PRS agent to Irida.
Yeah, so you all are privy to the drama.
You can just talk about
this
Scottish guy. Let's just leave it at that.
There's this Galushi fella.
Galushi.
Up north side of the mountain that happens to be next, or maybe current PRS agent. I don't know how I found that information, but I do.
Sounds yeah. good to me. Sounds like we have answers there.
That's not suspicious at all.
Nope.
How are those water boiling there? Very stupid.
I put my hand.
Don't try that boy
into the water. It's very hot.
Wait a minute. Do they not have boiling water where you're from?
Grab my. I know you know where the ice chest is. Will you go grab the ice for very stupid here and wrap that around his finger if you don't mind?
Yeah, sure. Olivia heads over to the freezer, which she has raided many times. Pending. His
Nehemiah.
So, I know there's probably nothing I can do to talk you out of going up there.
We need to find answers. And I met you. I mean, you looked at my research with me. I have nowhere else to go. This is the only lead I've had since I started looking this stuff up 6 months ago.
Yeah, all right. Well, I put that, obviously a mother's minivan in the barn in case somebody comes looking for it. Hope that woman had some form of insurance or compensation.
I know, we're gonna have to mail her some money.
You took her name and number before you took her car?
Detective Cross looked into...
Yeah, that was exactly the reason why we took that car.
He knows who she is. We will make
sure. Oh, okay. Well, you know, hopefully that young woman gets that minivan filled with children's toys back at a reasonable time. But I know you said people were looking for it, so I put it in the barn.
Thank you, Grandpa.
It's in the barn, and I got that old hunk of junk Lincoln fixed up for you if you don't...
That's perfect.
It's, you know, it's...
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Is it still green?
I mean, don't... It wasn't a big thing to fix it.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you know, it's
Graham
no big
Captain
deal.
Carlisle.
It's fine. It's, yeah, you know, really, it for my old body, it's not a big deal to be out in the hot
Grandpa,
sun all day.
Just, and you're the best.
Thank you, sweetie. That means a lot.
Apparently you've done something, and we are to thank you for it.
Alara.
The water is boiling.
Yeah, why don't you put your face in it? So I'll fix up the Lincoln. I don't, you know, it hasn't been on the road in years. You know, I got a little clever.
Yes.
So the tags were about from 98 on that thing, and the tires were a little off, so got some new tires on there, but I used that printer upstairs.
Grandpa!
And I printed on some colored paper. Your tags are good until 2018.
Grandpa, it doesn't work that way.
Drive at night and you'll be all right.
Oh my god!
That's actually kind of...
That's what we used to say in the Prohibition. I'm not that old.
Grandpa, that's illegal.
Well...
Our government needs those tax dollars to help keep libraries open.
Thank you very much, Grandpappy Carlisle.
It's Grandpa, it's just Grandpa. Actually, you guys can just call him Carlisle, it's fine.
You know, Carlisle's fine. You guys can all just call me Carlisle while you're in my house. That's very much fine. She can call me Grandpappy. That's okay.
I like Grandpa. Unless you want me to call you Grandpappy.
I'm not gonna ask twice.
So we're headed to some PRS agent's house.
How quickly should we leave? I mean, I feel like we haven't even prepared. I haven't made a checklist. I haven't gone through all my things.
Carlisle shushes you guys out of the kitchen into the living room as he starts chopping potatoes and getting ready for what is apparently just boiled potatoes. Hope you guys enjoy.
Nature's candy.
Nature's candy.
As you guys continue to formulate a plan in the living room.
Look, we shouldn't stay here long. I mean, we're lucky that no one actually saw your face in any of this stuff, but sooner or later, they're gonna start looking. If they even see one of us, they're gonna start digging.
It's true, and we have to make sure that Grandpa and nobody knows that we've been to Grandpa's house.
I agree. I think we should move soon. Part of me thinks that this is not going to be a safe place for very long.
Why would you think that?
Nothing has been.
That's true.
This is true.
Also, there was all that hollering this afternoon.
What hollering?
What hollering?
I don't know.
I don't.
I hear
don't
things
know.
Sometimes.
What hollering? What hollering? What happened? You guys.
I was just out there.
I don't know what hollering. I don't know.
Did you hurt the chickens?
I didn't hurt anybody.
Did you eat my grandpa's chickens?
No, no. He told me. You told me all not to do that before. Before when I almost did that one time. But I've learned not to go near the chickens.
What did you do?
Tell us about this Galushi fellow.
All right. Nebraska?
Tell us about Galushi.
All right. I don't know a lot about him. I met him as a child. And I had no idea, but apparently he was, or maybe still is, I'm not sure how it works, a part of PRS. And he lives in Colorado. I just remember his Scottish accent being very strong. And he used to bring me candy and weird toys, but I like the candy.
Candy, like potatoes?
Scottish.
Grandpa doesn't like sweets in the house, so he always frowned upon anything that wasn't natural. So no, not like potatoes. Much better. But I think we should try looking him up. I think he's gonna be he's the one lead we have.
So, just so we're all, you know, on the same page about this, we're not trying to kill this person.
No, we're never trying to kill anybody.
Or
okay, first of all, let's just discuss this since it's been brought up. You guys, we really need to try hard not to hurt people. Seriously. Lerida,
everybody we've seen in the last week who's not your grandfather has tried to kill us first.
Doesn't change what she's saying, though.
Not the cop. Not everybody.
He did pull a gun on us.
What would you have done? Not that I approve of his methods, but I mean...
His murder. Apparently I killed a man. We can't keep that happening.
And I don't...
Sometimes you don't have a choice.
There's always a choice.
If Erida and Cross want us to try and not hurt people, we should probably try not to hurt people.
Thank you. That's the only way I'm going to be able to get through this. And I need to stop having nightmares about the last week.
It'll be okay.
We need to figure this out. So this is the only lead we have. We need to find Miss Eves before something bad happens. I think we should probably leave soon.
Tonight?
Oh, geez, I need to pack.
Carlisle, hearing this as he's chopping potatoes, you know, I don't mean to rain on anybody's parade, but your friend Eves has been held captive for 6 days now.
It's a very long time to be a prisoner.
She's alive. She has to be alive, Grandpa. Don't worry.
I'm always amazed by your optimism, honey, but in this...
If
you have to ask yourself, are you really gonna risk all of this for somebody that's probably already dead?
She would have done the same for us, Grandpa.
Do you know that?
It's the only way we can find
I thought
find
you
answers.
Didn't know this woman, this big shot lawyer from Los Angeles.
She has nobody else.
It doesn't matter what she would have done for us.
It's our fault.
And I don't think they would have killed her. If they wanted to kill her, they would have killed her on the spot. They took her.
We lost her. We need to get her back.
You know, in the war, when you took somebody, it's to get something from them.
Oh, Grandpa.
And when you got what you needed, well, there were rules you had to follow, and some people, that's not how it shook down, you know?
Then we shouldn't waste any time.
These are the kind of people that follow the rules? Probably not. I don't know what's keeping them from killing her. It just seems like you're throwing a lot out there on the table to just risk so much for...
We have to try, because we have to do this, Grandpa. We still don't know why we all ended up at the hospital. There's a lot of unanswered questions. Where did they get those pictures of the three of them in white suits? Like, it seems more likely that all of them were at the hospital at one point. I still don't understand why I was even at the hospital. So, there's just a lot of unanswered questions. We need to continue forward. You know how I am with my research projects.
Yeah, I do. Help pay for that education. It's...
Thank you. I love you.
Potatoes are done. There's salt and pepper on the table if you need it.
Don't take the salt and pepper, just leave it. Thank you, Grandpa.
If you need to get going, I can put them in a plastic bag for you, but you're gonna wanna let them cool down. Sometimes the plastic melts to the potato and then you're in a bad situation, but throw them ice for a little bit and they're cooked. You can eat them whenever. You know.
Nature's perfect right. food.
I'm just gonna grab one with my right hand and just kind of take a bite out of it and just, all right, I got my potato.
Can you go, can you roll action for me?
Okay.
Oh, you're
just, my grandpa loves you.
Sounds tasty. 15, or sorry, 13.
Okay, I got luck, you're screwed.
Oh no. What's this potato
grass to grabs me? The potato, still steaming, really hot after he just explained that you're definitely not going to put it close to plastic because it'll burn plastic.
It's a robot head.
And he grabs it and takes a bite out of it, immediately like burning the upper part of his mouth and his tongue. He's now has a swollen tongue and makes speaking a little bit difficult.
They're hot. The potatoes are hot.
I'm going to put these on ice and put them in a bag for it. Erdic,
yeah,
come here, sweetie. Don't sleep with this
I
one.
I know, I love you, Grandpa. Grandpa, I love you. I would never lie to you.
No.
I don't like him.
Lord knows I've had some dumb ones in my day. This is a handful.
Is this about Jeff? Are you still bitter about Jeff? I know he wasn't very smart. He wasn't very smart, I get that. But it's
well,
not
if
like
you could keep a good one, that would be appreciated. You spend so much time in your books that you tend to forget the world around you, but
I'm apparently in the world now. I'm not in a book.
You're with murderers and freaks and this.
Remind me.
That man just took a robot arm and put a boiling potato in his mouth. I miss Jeff. I'm sorry.
He's a little slower, but you don't have to worry about it. I am not seeing him. Don't want to see him.
Just, oh God.
While I have
double up on the protection if you do. The last thing we need is our bloodline being continued by some aboriginal fucking idiot. Just, honey, be careful out there. Don't die. Don't get pregnant.
I'm not gonna get pregnant.
Just take the Lincoln. Take the potato and just call me, okay? Just call me.
Okay, I will.
And you
I
can
promise.
Tell me anything that you're
you.
Safe.
I will. Oh, before I forget, can you pass on these instructions to Millie, who's taking care of the cats? I don't know when I'm going to be able to get home again. And I don't know when
Millie,
I'm going to
call
her.
You want me to drive two states over just to
no.
give a note to...
No. She didn't answer last time I called her. So if you could just call her and tell her these instructions.
Oh. Thank you. Oh. Okay.
Thank you.
And so she's at your house?
Yes.
All the time? just hanging out in your place?
That's her number, Grandpa.
So it's a cell phone?
Yes.
A cellular device, got it.
Yes.
Pull up the fucking cell phone and just...
Right. I left a message, but I just want to make sure that she gets it.
Your cat. What's your cat's name again?
Cats. It's fine.
Oh, I'm sorry. What are your cat's names? All three of them.
There is Mocha. I mean, if you want to know. You really want to know?
I'm curious.
Mocha, Archimedes, and Gremlin.
Gremlin's still alive, huh? Even after I ran over his back legs that
one time? Yes, he just has a little bit of love.
I told you I should have put him down after that, but...
He is happy.
It's weird to me to put a creature like that through suffering for so much
years. He is doing great.
It was an accident when I... But...
What was it? He's just a little quirky. He's a quirky cat. What do you want from him?
What were their names again? No. Get out of here. Get on the road and just be safe, okay?
Thank you.
So you guys all pile into the Lincoln.
Thank you, Grandpa Carlisle.
Which has a rat's nest in the back. It's been sitting in the barn for years. He did clean up the outside to absolute perfection. There is not a spot on that car, brand new tires, but the inside has not been touched in 20 years for sure.
Oh, and well,
springs are coming out of the back seats. There's a little rusted hole in the front right where you can see the highway underneath the seat.
Do we have a board that we could put there?
Car purrs, though.
Beautiful.
Runs.
What color is it?
Black.
Black.
The Lincoln. It's black.
Oh, okay.
Or dark blue. Yeah, you know, one of the two.
Close enough.
And you all make your way north through the mountains. On your way out of town, you notice about six police cars passing you 2 miles outside of where you just left your grandfather's location. Nebraska looks and notices and doesn't seem to say anything to the rest of the group, and you guys all kind of look at each other hoping that that was something, in this instance, unrelated to you all.
A lot of crime in this part of town?
I'm sorry? Up?
I said a lot of crime in this part of town?
No, I have no idea. I don't remember the cops ever coming out this way before.
I might want to call your grandpappy just in case. See how he's doing.
What? Oh my gosh.
We're gone. I'm sure it's fine.
Now you got me worried. I'm gonna call Grandpa.
So you're now 3 miles from the house?
Yeah, I'm just gonna call Grandpa.
Okay.
Detective Cross is making me worried.
All right.
You're not driving, are you?
Yes.
You're driving?
No. No, no, no. Oh.
She's driving. Oh. I mean, you want it on, it's on speaker, right?
Yeah, it's on speaker.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
So. Hello.
Hi, Grandpa.
Hello, Grandpa Carlisle.
Sorry, you're on speaker. I'm sorry, I'm driving. You know, you can't drive and...
You just left.
I know, I just...
Is the car running okay?
Yeah, no, it's beautiful.
Tires are great, right?
It's amazing. Thank you.
You know, I waxed that thing for 2 days.
It's so shiny. People are going to be able to see us coming for miles. It's gorgeous.
Yeah, it's a nice car.
It's a gorgeous
car. It's a really nice car.
So beautiful.
Now...
Yes?
What are you calling me for?
Oh, so...
You just left here.
I know.
Are the potatoes okay?
Are amazing. Perfect food, as you always say.
You haven't slept with the idiot yet? Then what in the hell are you calling me for? You just got out of the house. What do you want?
I just saw a bunch of cop cars driving out towards...
You know? Oh, I don't think you gotta worry. It looks like they pulled up to the old neighbor's house. You remember Judy, right?
Judy?
Years ago. She had a couple kids you used to play with. Well, looks like they pulled up over at Judy's. It doesn't...
What are they doing at Judy's house?
I don't stick my nose in other people's shit. We're fine. Get back. Pay attention to the road.
All right.
Talking
okay.
on the phone while you're driving.
Right.
You
we
know, kids die that way. I saw a commercial once.
That's why you're on speakerphone.
All these...
You're absolutely right.
Blurred out images
I
and
know.
Stuff.
It's
when
terrible.
People talk on the phone, it's really
it's
dangerous
worse.
While they're driving. So
have a nice day, sir.
Love you.
I...
What? Wonder why they're at my neighbor's place. Judy, like, pretty much keeps to herself all
the time. I have to tell
you
all something.
You didn't eat her, did you?
No, she's fine. She's fine.
Wait a minute. You talked to Judy?
She needed some help with...
What?
Some device in her...
What kind of help? What are we talking about?
She said she needed a big, strong man to help her out. Then she asked me inside for some iced tea. It was very lovely.
Oh, well.
I've heard.
But she may or may not have recognized me from the magic box in her home.
Huh.
I'm sorry, I just...
She recognized you?
I'm sorry, yes, I'm so...
Oh, no.
Call Carla back right now, he has to get out of there.
Call Grandpa.
Have him go to, like, the store or something, just make an excuse to leave, and then he has to keep driving.
Got my grandpa in trouble.
Is anybody gonna get that?
Nobody picks up the phone at Carlisle's house. Thank you, Joe.
He's probably just talking to the cops.
find out that he had a bunch of people at his house that were on the news for being terrorists.
It'd be a lot worse if we turned around. Then they would know for a fact that he was harboring.
Except a car from LA is in his garage.
That was an unregistered car. Like, for all we know, it could have been from Nevada, it could have been from Arizona.
He has no children. Why does he have a van with children's toys in his... Oh my god.
If we turn around, are we gonna get in another fight with a bunch of cops?
Oh my god.
We should just keep going.
Why does this always happen?
Look, your grandfather's a capable man with a shotgun.
He's not gonna shoot the cops!
I'm just saying, he's a capable man. He just happened to threaten with the shotgun 3 or 4 times a day.
But, I'm sorry about that, by the way. My grandpa's a little protective.
It's all right. It's a valid point, but he'll take care of himself. He knew what he was getting into when he found out that we had powers.
He can't say no to me. I'm his granddaughter. He's the only family I have.
He's a good man, but... Look, Erida. We'll help him best by staying away at this point. It's kind of clear at this point that wherever we go, mayhem's gonna follow.
Yeah, but... We can't just leave him.
But we can't go back.
Ring! Ring! Your phone starts to ring and it's your grandpa's number.
I answer it.
Okay. Oh, hey, sorry, honey. I didn't expect you to call again so fast. I see all your number on the missed call. I was taking a shit. I don't get any time to myself since you've been here, and I get 10 minutes in the bathroom by myself and the phone starts ringing again.
Sir.
Yeah.
You're compromised.
Is that...
You're on
hold on, wait, what? Sorry, it's all echoey, and are you... I mean, you're in the car still talking to me again. Why'd you pick up if you're driving?
It's on speaker.
You know, I saw a commercial once.
Carlisle, listen to me. You're being compromised right now.
Did that boy just clap at me?
Yes, I did, sir.
Grandpa,
Nebraska was cited. He went over to your neighbor's house. She knows about the news.
What? That fucking idiot? God damn it, we told that stupid son of a bitch to stay the fuck on my property and not talk to anybody!
I'm sorry, Grandpa.
Air to ditch that stupid cocksucker right now! Put him on the side of the goddamn road! You know what? Don't... This is still on speakerphone, isn't it?
Yeah.
You're a fucking idiot! I told you to stay... Don't talk to anybody. Okay. Alright. Okay, so the police are gonna talk to Judy. Well, god damn, that woman likes to talk. She's gonna talk and talk. Okay. What? Cross. You stole that car from a woman, didn't you?
I stole it from an unmarked license plate. They won't be able to track it.
It's unmarked? Okay. Alright. I'm gonna go take the license plates off the front and the back of that car, and I'll throw them in the bottom of the horse manure. Nobody'll ever know.
Get rid of the toys as well.
I don't need to get rid of the.
Just get rid of the toys, Grandpa. People are gonna be like, if they look in there, they're gonna be weirded out that they're toys.
I've got grandkids. Nobody asks an old man why they have toys.
Yeah, how old are your grandchildren?
You know, the longer we argue about, look, I'll ditch the license plates. I'll ditch the license plates. You ditch the idiot. We'll be fine. Okay. Just don't worry about me. Look, you remember how every time when your mother was still alive and you guys would come over and she'd ask me to do stuff and I'd pretend I couldn't hear?
Yeah.
I'll do the dumb old man trick. It works every fucking time.
Right.
I'll do the dumb old man trick. Look, they'll never... You said they don't know. There's been no pictures of you, right?
No pictures that I know of, no.
Okay. I'm gonna tell them you came for a visit.
Okay.
Just you.
Just me.
Just you. I know nothing
about... I don't have any other friends.
Idiot 1, 2, and 3.
Nope. I'm sorry. You guys aren't idiots. But Grandpa, you're still on speakerphone. You probably realize that. I'm aware. But just a reminder. And sounds good. Call me later.
Ditch the idiot! And he hangs up.
You know, I think really he's taking a shine to you.
Sorry about that, guys. He's a little colorful, that one.
Why does he think you two are sleeping together?
Oh my gosh, can we not talk about that? I turn on the radio really loud and just start driving.
So as
I don't even care what station it
our
is.
Caravan continues moving, our vagabonds continue making their way north into the mountains of Colorado. You all start discussing a plan on what you might do when you get there. It just occurred to you that you probably can't just show up at a strange man's house, a group of you, most of you being wanted citizens, and even if you do, will he give you the information?
Hey, look, Erida, I know you're being a little bit cagey about this, but who is this Galushi guy? Like, how do you know him? You don't need to tell us a lot, but...
He knew my father.
Your father?
Yeah.
So your dad knew someone in the PRS?
Why would you just come out and say that? Why would you say that?
Because your grandfather was talking about Galushi in the PRS. And like, he's a good man, but he's not a good liar.
He didn't say anything about my dad.
No, he said Galushi is in PRS. So I'm saying, why does your father know someone in the PRS?
I'm kind of stuttering at this point to like find an explanation because I'm a really bad liar. So I just tell you his truth. I'm like, listen, I just found out today that apparently my dad was involved in the PRS as well. He's dead now, so can't get any answers from him. Not that I'd want to go talk to him anyways, but apparently they were in the PRS together and just learned that today, so that's real fun. That's always awesome.
That's good. I mean, it's terrible. I'm sorry for your loss, but that's good. There's a connection then. That means he knows you, at least.
I haven't seen him since I was a little girl, and I'm pretty sure he knows that I hated my father.
Look, if I learned one thing, is that when someone's gone, you try to find out about them. You try to make a connection that you can't make anymore. You were just trying to find out about your dad, that's a reason to be there. Doesn't even need to be about PRS.
That's the best thing we've got, I guess, so...
Look, at the very least, you can look around, and then while you're doing that, we can just look around the building. Maybe it has, like, I don't know, a garage, a hidden base underneath this house that has video surveillance cameras.
Wait, you're gonna just like, so...
That was a joke, by the way. I hope.
We're gonna find out where he lives, which I don't have that information. I have a black book of names and numbers and things, but who knows how old this thing is. And so we have to figure out where this guy actually lives.
Didn't Grandpappy Carlisle say he knew he lived just north?
He knows the town, but we don't have an address. I mean, I'm pretty sure if we go into town, these towns are pretty small. We can probably go to the local bar. We can go to the local tavern and ask where the Scottish guy is.
As we're talking, I'm immediately going to Google and starting to look at Joe Galushi and the name of the town. Search. I've learned my lesson.
Yeah. All right, roll for intellect. Wow, you guys are doing great. That's the first roll for intellect tonight.
I'm doing the fucking search on Google. I rolled a 5.
Whitepages.com.
Yeah. So yes, I switched from Google to actually looking at a phone listing website.
Yes, Detective Cross typing in Galushi's name does come across whitepages.com, which is just a transcript of the phone book. And on White Pages, it doesn't list the address, but you remember that phone books actually will list the street address of some. If you can know their name and the number, it will list the street address. So you need to find a phone book when you get to the town.
All right. Best we can look for is either a motel, phone booth, or maybe like a diner somewhere. If we're lucky, they might have one. Do you know anyone else in this town, Erida?
Not that I can think of. I've never actually been to this town before.
If there's a rest stop, rest stops have phone booths. Phone booths have yellow books.
But we need the White Pages. Do phone booths rent? I don't even know the last time I used a phone book. I mean, I know apparently my grandpa gets one still, so maybe it's a local thing. I'm sure we could find one at the local library or a diner or something in town.
We'll figure it out.
Plot point. I'm going to use a plot point here. As you're driving in, conversing, you're now 3 hours into your trip in the mountains. Even in the summer, there's a bite to the air. extremely cold this high up. Your back left tire blows. And you luckily are able to maintain control of the car as you pull off just to the right on a little shoulder overlooking a valley in the mountains and one of the pull-off spots for an overlook.
What was that?
Alara of Nebraska, it's nothing to be concerned about. We apparently blew a tire. Let me take a look. I get out of the car, see how bad it is.
So it looks like your pappy only put new tires on the front and rotated the old tires in the back.
Oh, Grandpa.
So to save money, of course.
Save money.
They looked fine.
He's retired.
So the back tire is weathered, and you can see that it's just completely blown, and you're on the rim, so it will definitely have to be changed.
Okay. I open the trunk to see if there's a spare.
There is a spare.
Oh, sweet.
There is some mercy out there.
It is a donut, though.
All right, well, we're probably... How far do I know how close the next
three
is?
More hours.
Three more hours. Are there any towns in between?
Yes.
So I think we're going to have to just put the spare on and drive into the next place that we can and get a new tire. We still have some money left, so I'll have to do. Although I probably can use my cards. I'm going to say, being a farm girl, my grandpa, taught me how to change a tire. So I'd like to try to bring those memories back from my childhood.
Okay, can you roll Mike for me, please?
Aw, man. Got this. No big. 5.
Okay. So, Erda opens up the trunk and you guys are still sitting in the car and you hear her grunting outside and straining to try to lift the donut out of the back of the car, but she is unable to handle this on her own.
Hey, Nebraska.
I'll go help her out.
Livy just gets out of the car so she can jack it up.
Hey guys, can you... Apparently I don't remember how to do this, or maybe I'm just not strong as I used to.
It's might.
Yeah, so. I apparently, being in the library is not the best for my muscles.
I just reach past her and grab the tire.
Okay.
Really? So. That easy? He doesn't have to roll anything? Really? Fine. That's cool. Cool. Good job.
I don't have to hide out here. It's great.
Whoa. What time of day is it?
Oh, it's night.
Okay. All right. So he can put it down and I can still change it, because I'm not going to trust him to change the tire.
I don't.
So just place it here, please.
Walk him through it.
Okay, so I
just hold the tire here.
I just
hold
put
on.
The tire down.
All right,
just I'll stop it from rolling.
Okay, just hold it. Okay, I get my tools.
How are those potatoes?
And they're pretty good.
They're good, right?
Leave me a potato. Just saying. Just leave me a potato, please. I undo one bolt. How many bolts is that on the tire? 8. There are 8 bolts.
Are you driving
4?
A semi?
I undo the 4 bolts.
We'll say 5.
I undo the 5 bolts.
Not important, really.
Bolt.
So you're just taking the tire off before jacking up the car?
Oh, no, I thought Olivia... I thought you said you jacked up the car
for us. No, I said I got out so that you could.
Oh, I thought you said you did it for me.
Apologies.
It's all right, so now the tire bolts are off and on the ground, and she goes to try to pull it, but the tire's still...
Oh, just joking, guys. Missed a step.
Do you need some help now?
Hold on. Alara of Nebraska. Put it under. Can you push this down to help me jack up the car, please?
So, you put the jack underneath, and Nebraska sees what you're trying to do and grabs the car with his arm and just picks it up.
Oh, that's wonderful. Thank you. That's very handy that you can do that.
I was actually going to use a plot point on doing that.
Well,
so thank you for saving that for me.
Take off the old broken up tire pieces. Put on our donut. Rescrew it into place. Put the car.
How do you rescrew it?
With the tool.
I'm sorry, you trolled me with the Scottish thing. I'm kidding.
Damn you! You know what's really funny?
Tidy.
My mom told me that I should learn how to do that, and I was like, "Hey, somebody, mom." good old days.
So you just screw it back on?
Yeah, right, to the right, going righty-tighty with my tools.
Righty-tighty, okay.
Pew, 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 pew.
Oh, this is great.
Pew, pew, pew.
So your manual wrench makes noises, you got that.
Cool. I just like to make noises when I do things.
Great.
Yeah.
So.
Like me, yeah, like bam.
Tightens the tire down and puts it back on, and Nebraska drops the car, and you guys now have a little donut that's a couple inches smaller than the other, so the whole car is kind of riding like this.
We did it!
As you make your way down the opposite side of the mountain, at the bottom of the mountain.
Wow, that's a powerful car.
Purring like a kitten.
That went a lot smoother than I thought it was going to.
It's not over yet.
Don't need inspiration.
You make your way down the mountain, having to drive through some snow at the peak.
Uh-oh.
As you're up there, you notice the back end start to shake a little bit.
Oh no.
The whole car is starting to wobble, and you start to slide. Go ahead and roll action for me since you're driving.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to call that dexterity on this one.
Seven.
Eight.
Ah! Rolling an eight?
Yeah. This is when the job's fun.
Never a good thing when your GM looks
so
at you.
So as the back end of the car starts to shake, Erida starts to lose control a little bit. As the car slides the back end, she overcompensates and the car spins around and makes a slight stop on the guardrail, now pointed the opposite direction. Everyone's fine inside the car, but you're now pointed the opposite direction, and that back left tire was wobbling pretty bad. And you go out and give it a look, and you realize that the outer sides of each screw has kind of been worn completely out. Star pattern. Gotta do the star pattern. That's, you just tighten it up in a row, it just is gonna wobble shut. But so it's all, the tire's worn. And what do you do?
Something new every day.
How many hours are we from the town?
It's at the bottom of the hill, so you've got about another hour to go.
Is there any towns in between?
And only probably about 20 more miles till you're out of the snow.
Well, we could call a tow truck.
Yeah.
Do you have AAA and, license
that's probably
plate.
Going to be pretty expensive, and we don't have that much cash on us. I'd rather not leave a trail.
Our pictures are also on the television.
Our faces are in magic boxes all over the place.
Oh, that's right. I forget about that. Oh.
Can we just...
Nothing can be easy.
Take it off and fix it? I mean, you just
fixed
it
last time. I mean, we could try. Let's try. Let's do it. This time I'll remember the right order of how to do things. Let me...
You're going to try to take
it. Look at that smirk. Evil. I'd like to try to re-tighten things. Alara, may I have your assistance again, please?
Of course. I just pick it up again, I guess.
Yeah.
I mean, you can. It's you're just tightening.
You got a super
arm. And Erida starts to tighten the pattern, but seeing that the holes around the around the bolts has been worn, you can tighten all you want. You're not going to get a good seal because it's warped and worn around the bolts.
Do you have anything in the trunk,
anything in the trunk you
like
would...
Like foam spray or something that helps seal it?
Foam spray?
I don't know what the problem
is. Erida goes into the back of the car and pulls out some foam sealant and sprays it into the holes. And,
I'm just...
Cross is pretty certain that that's probably not going to work.
Detective Cross, do you have any ideas of how we might be able to correct this?
I got lots of ideas, but I'm having a really good time just watching y'all right now.
Oh, no.
Gosh, shut up, Mr. Geist.
Mr. Geist, do you happen to have any ideas for us?
Let me check.
Oh, no.
I have plenty of great ideas.
Why would you ask him that?
I was trying to be polite.
What do you think we should do, Gregarious Gentile Mr. Geist?
Have a potato.
How can we solve this problem?
Potato. It's a potato! This thing is nasty.
Hey, that's nature's candy. These are delicious. I grab the potato from him and take a bite.
Oh, my gosh.
Disgusting. See, the way I see, y'all have two concepts right now. You could either, you know, call up a taxi cab and all that, and, you know, answer a bunch of dumb questions like, you know, why is this tag expired with a printed out piece of paper on the back? Or y'all could hoof it or hide the car and hope that your grandpappy comes back at some point and picks it up. It's only a mile and a half. What's the worst that could happen except slipping on the ice and falling and breaking your neck? It'll be a party. Bye-bye. Guys?
Hi. Hi, Detective.
It's all downhill from here to the,
You're currently pointed back up the mountain at the way you hit the guardrail, but it is all downhill down the mountain.
Wait. Okay. And so we can see the lights of the city. I can see from
there. We're gonna need a car, though.
What if we slid down?
What?
That is such a bad idea. I'm gonna roll for intellect to see this.
That's a good idea.
I'm just like, that's such a bad idea. I'm thinking about my driving course in the cop school.
Voluntarily rolling for intellect.
That's a 10.
I'm pretty lucky this time.
I'm gonna use a plot point.
Okay.
And spread my arm out as thin as it can so it can be as wide as it can and try to create something that resembles a toboggan.
What?
A toboggan? How are you gonna sit on it? For
no. I'll kind of have to stab on the back, but if we can try to make it as big as possible so we can all just sit on it and sort of slide down to the city.
So you guys are gonna leave the car and
slide
down the hill.
You know, we could just try to drift the car down the hill.
Yeah, why don't we just.
No, this is a great plan.
Because that's what
we slide down.
He used a plot point for
this.
And
we can stop a lot easier
this
way. This
is a really good description of what should happen. So
we're gonna sled down.
Can I?
We can't just put it in neutral and guide it down.
We can both. How about I follow you guys?
I'm just saying, if we
in the car.
Do take a toboggan, we still need to move the car and put it out somewhere, or else, you know, a police officer is gonna come sooner or later for an abandoned car and go to your.
I'm going to my grandfather's. Exactly. And be like, who drove the car? That's not going to work out so well. As much as I love your creativity, Alara of Nebraska.
It seems to me like the car wasn't moving, so I thought we could.
Point of fact, is this really a really big toboggan you just made with this arm? Like, it could actually fit us?
Yeah, there's a really giant, hold on. It could fit two of you. We're gonna say it could fit two of you. There's a really large, flat, sled-like thing that has grown out of his arm, extremely thin, barely connected to his arm still, which seems to have exhausted him a little bit, but he's very proud of his creation with a large grin on his face.
I would like to use plot point.
Yes.
Livia has watched a lot of television in her time here at various homeless shelters and remembers this TV show that she saw where they were in a very similar kind of situation and pipes up and says, maybe like you can use your arm or your strength or something to kind of like brace the car and then we can like guide it down the hill like all of us just pushing, you know, I think this is a thing that could work.
I think we could just put the car in neutral.
We can just put the car in neutral.
And just guide it carefully down the hill to the town.
You expect these wheels to turn on the snow?
You can use your arm and your strength.
Then yes, let's do it together.
You don't know about magic boxes, but you know about buoyancy of a car.
I have carts where I'm from.
Do not question the plan.
But you don't have hot water where you're from?
No.
Where are you from?
We invented the wheel long before we had figured out how to just magically make things hot. We learned how to cut a circle into wood. Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Wait, Nebraska, where are you from?
A place called Loam.
Where?
Loam.
It's another world.
What? Is that in Europe or something?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
What? Another one.
Livy just accepts this. All right, let's push the car now.
What?
Wait.
Have you never met somebody from another world?
I've seen them on TV trying to destroy the world.
The car is facing down the hill backwards, and Livia is outside coaching as Cross and Erida are in the front. Erida still driving, looking over her shoulder in neutral, trying to go backwards as Alara is trying really hard to brace the back left tire and use like a little bit of like the shape that he had made for a sled to catch underneath and guide it as the car starts rolling
backwards. So I'm just like hanging off the back with my right arm underneath
the
tire.
You're kind of standing with your feet like holding it behind it as it's moving back. And can you roll intellect for me?
What am I about to do?
Joe, I do not appreciate this.
Three. Oh,
God. So as he gets behind the car and puts the sled-like thing under it and the car goes into neutral, it starts to work and the car starts to move backwards as it comes up on his arm. And Nebraska gets extremely excited because he sees the car is moving. He's like, guys, it's working! And then the car immediately backs up on top of him and rolls up on top of Nebraska, which is now... his arm is now tangled in the wheel spoke and he's slightly underneath the car, but it worked for a split second. It was a good plan.
That was a good plan.
So wait, the car started moving though. Did it stop?
It stopped when it hit you.
Okay. How pinned am I?
You're pinned enough that you're a little tangled. You could probably work your nanites back into their regular shape, but it's going to take you a little bit because they got a little tangled up in
okay.
there. And once that's unhooked, you could probably lift the car and move out. But it's gonna take you a little bit.
Wait there for a little bit. I'm gonna try to, but I'm just gonna kind of just be there.
Okay,
I'll try it for a while.
Thank you, audience. Plot point. No. You think I want to stick here? No. I'm mad at myself.
Okay, good. You should be.
Livia sitting in the front of the, or standing outside the car and seeing the town below, realizes that nobody's checked to see if the cell phone gets any reception up here, and grabs the phone and pulls up the internet and starts looking immediately for a tow truck service to call and come out. Realizing though that just calling a tow truck might be a bad idea, Erida instructs everyone to hide in the bushes. Just offside the road, because nobody knows to look for Erida. And they give her an estimate of about 20 minutes before the tow truck will show up.
Okay. This could have been worse. I don't know how, but it could have been worse.
Let's not say that. You never know.
When you described the back of the car as a rat's nest, to what degree was that euphemism?
It means there used to be a rat's nest in the. There was a rat's
okay.
nest left in the back of the car.
After I untangle myself from underneath the car, I'm gonna look for rats.
Underneath. So as Nebraska's arm starts forming itself back into his right arm, and he's underneath, he notices a couple trails of stuff up under there, and sees a little tail sticking out from under, like above the gas tank, wedged in between. And
yeah, I'm gonna try to grab that bad boy.
All right. So he reaches up and grabs the squealing rat, and immediately the arm consumes it, disintegrating all of the protein. And you guys just hear a slight squeal, but that's about it.
You good, Nebraska? What's that?
I'm a little stuck, but I'll get out soon.
Is there anything we can do to help so we can get out of here by 20 minutes?
Hide. The three of you get behind the truck and all lift at once and are able to pull Nebraska out.
Impressive.
What do you do now? Tow truck is about 10 minutes away.
Is there like the side of the road? Can we actually go there and be well hidden, or is it like a sheer drop off?
There's a sheer drop off on the guardrail side where the car is, but on the opposite side of the road going uphill are snow and trees.
Alright, I'm gonna say let's go this way towards the tree line so we at least can see lights coming.
Alright, so how are we going to meet back up?
I'll wait until there's only one.
No, but I'm gonna be going with the tow truck.
Don't we still have the burners that I got from before?
Mm-hmm.
So you've got your phone? We've got a phone. We'll meet back up.
Okay. So we're going. You guys are gonna walk, or should I come back and get you?
Oh, and technically this is Grandpa's phone.
Oh.
Because she didn't have phone for us. This is Grandpa's cell phone that you're using.
Yeah.
Okay. So let me make sure that I have her number first, and we'll just walk down while you're dealing with the tow truck guy. Does that
sound. I say we should probably wait just in case there's... Is there a way we can actually walk down the road without being seen by it? Or is it just...
To walk down the road? You're going to be seen. If you're walking on
yeah,
the road...
Yeah, we just have to wait until they're gone then.
Walk, like, beside the road.
Yeah.
You could go up into the trees if you wanted to hide. I wouldn't suggest walking up or down the road given it's snow-covered and extremely dangerous terrain, but you could probably cross the street and hide in the bushes and trees up there.
Yeah, I'd say we wait until they're gone and then we start walking down by the road again because... I don't want to be one of those stories of the black man being caught in the middle of Colorado North and dead in the woods. I've seen horror movies before.
It happens around here?
Yes.
Why does Colorado hate black guys?
This is getting really uncomfortable. Never.
All right, so we're we're heading towards the trees to hide,
yes.
And then going to walk at the trees along the road.
Yes.
Get as much
and
cover as we can.
For
no, no, just no. We'll stay down there. We'll meet you in about an hour or two.
We'll find
that
you.
Will get us a hotel then. Or do you think we should just keep going?
We should just
keep going. All right, we're just gonna keep going.
You can so you can take care of the tow truck and the replacing of the tire.
We're meeting in that town down there.
Yes.
Okay.
All right, and as you guys are making your way across the street, you notice headlights coming up the mountain, and you hear the grinding of tires and with chains working their way on the asphalt up the hill. Pulling around. Oh, hey there! How you doing there?
Hi.
Oh, yeah!
Hi.
Out here trapped in the snow, are you?
Yeah.
Yeah, you need some help?
I would love some help.
Okay, well, we're gonna help you out. It's gonna be no problem there. So I've got a couple different options for you.
All right.
Okay, well, you know, I could hook you up with a pretty simple ordeal if you got the money for it, but it is a little bit more expensive, so I just want to be right up front with you, you know, and let you know that it's gonna, might cost you a pretty penny, but I do have a couple extra tires on the back here. I could just change out the tire for you, but it's gonna run you about $200 there, and those aren't my prices. I don't mean to, now see that face, I knew that face was coming. I wasn't trying to, you know, I know it's cold out here and I want to help. And, you know, I'll do whatever I can to help, but please just understand those are prices that my boss sets and I don't have anything to do with it. I'm just spreading the word, you know?
How much are the tires in town?
Well, the tires in town are considerably cheaper. I'm, you know, no joke about that. But, you know,
I appreciate your honesty.
It's going to be about $120 to get you towed down the hill and then maybe another $50 for the tires. So really, you're only saving about $20 to have me just do it right here.
I'll take it.
Okay, that sounds like a deal. You know, it's a little cold. If you want to warm up inside my truck. Now, I'm sorry. That was really rude of me. Ma'am, I'll fix your tire for you. If you would, you know, there's no way for me to ask you to sit in my truck without sounding a little bit creepy. I realize now.
What is your name, sir?
Oh, my name is Jan.
Jan?
Yep.
Jan.
It's a woman's name, I know, but you know.
Jan's
sometimes you just gotta deal
Jan,
with what the Lord
love
gives
that
you.
That is a wonderful name. It's a beautiful name.
Oh, I appreciate that. I appreciate you, you know, being all kind and stuff like that. But, you know, it's no big deal. It's fine.
Okay.
Jan, well, you know, you know, here I'm asking you to get... Your car still runs now, doesn't it?
Yes.
You should just sit in your car with the heat on there. But if I ask you to turn the car off, if you don't mind, the exhaust, start breathing it in back there,
really,
and it gets
don't.
A little...
I'd rather not.
It gets
you
to my head
know.
A little
what
bit.
What if I accidentally hit something? It just, that makes me feel uncomfortable. If it's okay.
Okay, well, let's... You know what? Let's have a look at your tire here.
Okay,
and,
let's do that.
Okay, Oh, I see there.
What seems to be the problem?
Well, you know... You tried to change this tire yourself now, didn't you, man? You know, I knew how to do it one way.
You know what? I used to be much stronger back in the day when I used to work
it's
on
my okay.
grandpa's
like,
farm.
You know what?
I don't work on the farm
it's,
as much
It's
anymore.
The day and age we live in. I don't want you to be embarrassed. There's all sorts of people that come out here and, you know, you'd be surprised. I wish people knew how to change their own tire, but I'd be out of business if they did, so... I can't really look down on you or judge you for that, so...
Yeah, it's fine. You can judge me a little bit. I understand.
Okay, well, you know... the star pattern. You know,
you... It came to me late.
You know, I commend you for trying to put the tire on in the first place. That's a real commendable thing to do out here in the cold, but...
Thank you.
You can see if you... When you put it on, you tighten it. You go across in a star pattern, and you... You tighten it there, and then you come down, like, you know, like you used to draw the star in grade school and stuff like that?
Yep.
It's a piece of cake to remember.
Yep, it just somehow left me.
Oh, you know, I understand. It's okay. Well, you know, I'm going to change the tire for you. Just Ma'am, if you don't mind, I like to have some privacy while I work. I like to sing some show tunes and stuff like that. It's just...
Absolutely, Gian. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you know.
I can sing with you if you want, but...
Please don't.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, if you can just... My car or your car, ma'am. I don't care which one. I gotta put your tire on.
I'm gonna go to your truck.
Okay, it's a little cold out here. Thank you. Wait, my truck? You didn't have to make it weird, ma'am. Oh, whatever. It's fine. So, Jan continues changing the car tires. It takes about 20 minutes, and, all right, ma'am. Yeah.
Wait, I didn't hear the show tunes.
You're not supposed to hear the show tunes. That's why I asked for privacy. It helps pass the time out in the cold, you know?
Could we, when
Absolutely.
We're, those of us that are watching, could we hear the show tunes?
Yeah.
Okay.
Most definitely.
What did they sound like? You want to give us a...
It was basically the entire soundtrack to Chicago.
Okay.
Oh, that's a good soundtrack.
But, so,
All right, so $200?
It's $200, yeah.
Perfect. Here you are.
Okay, well, I need the $200 now.
Oh, hold on. It's in my purse in the car. 1 second.
Okay, and I don't mean to be weird, but I am going to watch you, ma'am.
That, Jan, I totally understand.
All right, I just don't want you running off.
I have $200 for you.
I mean, I don't know where you'd go, but still, it's... Good business practice.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I count the 200 in the car so he doesn't see, like, all my money.
Why are you being so protective over there, ma'am? You know, I'm not gonna rob you or anything out here. I'm a businessman. With the Yelp and all those things like that, it wouldn't be very good of me to go robbing somebody out in the middle of nowhere and then have it showing up all over my Yelp page and shit. There's nothing for you to be worried about.
I'm not worried. It's just... I have a very particular way of counting money.
Ma'am, I'm trying not to be offended here, but it, okay.
Here, $200.
Just, all right, just 200, huh?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
You know,
I've never paid
It's really cold up here on the mountain, and I got kids to feed, and.
I'm so sorry. I've never actually had my tire changed by somebody before.
Oh, what you know, we don't ask for tips. We're not allowed to ask for tips. Oh. That's kind of, it would be really rude of me to do so,
wonderful.
But it's kind of customary in the United States when you do an act of service.
So,
for an individual.
What
and,
is a proper tip for something like this? $20?
Oh, you're asking me? Well, typically, ma'am, it's around 40 to 50 cents, depending on how good you feel about the job I did.
$40?
Well, it's all, I mean, if you think I did a $20 job, I'll take $20. I mean, that's all up to you. I mean,
I don't want to offend you. I'm so sorry. Got,
the tire does have a 3-month guarantee on it now. I don't know where you're headed, but.
Do I have papers for that?
Oh, well, we keep a record. We keep track of your license plate and all that.
Is there a receipt that I can get that's shipped?
A receipt? Well, yeah, you'll get a receipt. I'm a good businessman. Like okay. I said, I gotta keep the Yelp score
right,
up.
Perfect. Okay, 240. 50. 50.
Oh, 250. All right. You know what? Thanks, ma'am. I really appreciate it. You know, you be really careful out there. That you're traveling all by yourself out here in the mountains.
I know.
And, you know, when you get down into town, there's a little diner down there. It's the best damn pancakes you ever gonna have.
I love pancakes.
Oh, you check it out, yeah.
Okay. Wonderful.
All right.
Thank you so
all
much.
All right. Well, thank you, ma'am.
I'll make sure to check out your Yelp page.
Oh, yep. You know, a 5-star review goes a long way for us small business owners.
Absolutely.
You know, it's a real racket they're running on that thing. You get one bad review and they're all over you. You know, like, you got it. It's really tough. You know, it puts you in a real weird position as a business owner to have to ask people to review you well.
You didn't even ask me.
Usually when you do something and you like the job that's been done, you just like it. You know, but now with the Yelp page and stuff, you gotta encourage people to go tell people how much you like it. Otherwise, the negative people just they tell everyone about
what
it.
What does this world come to?
It's a real. You know, it's really cold out here, ma'am. I'm gonna leave.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
All right.
I will make sure to go on your Yelp page.
5 stars, thank you.
5 stars, you're welcome.
All right.
All right, thank you.
So Jan drives down the mountain, waving. All right, as he's driving out, waves goodbye, and you guys. See now that the car is still there and the tire has been replaced.
I'm never getting those 20 minutes back in my life.
Wait, what just happened? I thought.
Oh my god, I don't care.
Did it not work?
Warm car.
It's perfect. Right, so we didn't have to go in. It's all good. Get in the car. We're going.
Libby practically dives into the back seat. Oh my god, it's so cold.
Can you guys all roll might for me?
God. Hey guys.
Natural 20.
11.
20.
13.
Okay, so,
nothing's good enough.
Nebraska, being from Nebraska and Loam and have lived many, many nights out in the cold, is pretty like, yeah, you know, whatever, feels pretty good. And Cross and Livia, on the other hand, take a couple points of damage to their armor and are extremely freezing, but luckily the Lincoln has been kept warm and you guys will warm up here pretty soon. Our vagabonds continue heading down the mountain.
He knows a show tune.
It's gonna be stuck in my head for the next year because I just heard it once. So.
I've seen that movie.
So you guys make your way down the mountain.
I like that guy.
Headed towards Walden. Now about 30 minutes out. Having one last chance to formulate a plan.
All right. So let's just go over this again. I am going to... I can't go show up at this guy's house in the middle of the night, though. Like, are we seriously just going straight to his house?
What time is it right now? Or what time would be when to get there?
It's going to be about 10 p.m.
That's really late.
Oh, sorry, wait. No, it's going to be about 2 a.m.
2 a.m.
We can't do that. He's going to be sleeping. That's super suspicious.
So we get a hotel and we go in the morning?
I think we should get a hotel and we should go in the morning.
Motel?
Motel, hotel, yeah.
Holiday Inn.
I wasn't going to do what you did.
All right, I mean, I'm perfectly in agreement with you that we shouldn't go tonight, but in the middle of the daytime, four of us driving up, it's going to look a little bit conspicuous.
True.
Wait till night.
All right, let's do that. Let's wait till tomorrow night and we'll go more around like 8-ish or 7 or somewhere where it's not totally unheard of to knock on a stranger's door.
But also dark. Well, what are we going to do while you go talk to him?
I thought...
We should probably look around.
Wants to look around the house.
You know, and if we're being particularly clever about it, you can just call us and keep a line open. That way we at least will know if something's going on. Because this guy's PRS, and if you're in there alone, that's going to be kind of worrisome.
What do you mean?
I'm just saying that PRS, everyone that we come through so far, has tried to shoot us in the head.
Oh, yeah.
Or capture us.
That's a good point.
I'm just saying, I feel really bad. You've been nice to us and you don't actually have to stay. You're not wanted, so.
We're in this together.
Also,
we've already talked about this.
Nobody seems to catch your picture in anything.
Let's not worry about that too much right now. I'm sure we'll.
Okay, so.
Sure.
Tomorrow night, you go knock on his door and we break in?
Maybe. We'll take a look around, see what we can find first.
So would you want to take a look inside or just like around the perimeter to get a better idea or?
We see what we find. I mean, worst comes to worst, breaking and entering is probably the least of our many, many crimes. I'm going to hell.
Oh my gosh. Let's not think about them as crimes. We're performing acts to save our friend.
We've been surviving.
And that. So what do I do after I talk to him and ask for
you
information?
You keep talking to him.
Okay.
As long as you can. Like, get information out of him as
Are
you can.
Are we gonna have a signal for, like, when I should leave or when you're leaving?
A safe word?
Yeah, or like, call, like, call or something.
Let's just say,
How are your bird sounds?
I could do a bird sound.
Yeah?
Totally.
So what would your bird sound be for me to know that it's time for me to go? That's a good bird sound, all right.
So the group pulls into Walden, Colorado.
God is.
Now about 2 a.m. Walden's a small town of about 600 people, and there are no hotels or motels.
Oh.
Especially none, well, there's one outside of town, but it is not open and there is no vacancy sign that is on given the time of night.
Oh, well.
The town is one long road driving through the center.
Is there anything open?
What about?
Not at this time of night.
What about a lot of small towns outside them will have rest stops?
You're off of any major interstates. This is a small county town. You have reception.
Do you want to Google to see if there's anything open?
I'll take a look. worst comes to worst, though, we can just pull on the side of the road and go sleep. I'll do a Google search to see if anything within like the 2 mile radius, 3 mile radius is open.
Roll intellect.
You know. Oops. 10.
10?
Yep.
You see that there is a bed and breakfast, though not open, says call any time for service.
Well, there is a bed and breakfast. You could say that you're just having a really long trip, got sidetracked.
Are you guys gonna sneak in though? How am I gonna get you in?
Just say that we're on a rope trip for
what
college.
What if they've seen your photos?
Just say E4. You don't have to actually show photo IDs, I hope. Never hurts to call.
Why don't we
These
do
are
some...
small towns, like people wanna know everything. They're gonna be very curious, especially because it's bed and breakfast. I could go by myself and then try to sneak you guys in. That will backfire.
I got us a key. I could do it again.
Alara, you did great last time, but I think that I shall get the keys from now on.
That's right. I'm on the magic box. You should get the key.
I will get the keys in the future. I mean, we could just sleep in the car. It's gonna be pretty cold though. What do you guys think?
Be kind of cramped.
I've
used to sleeping outdoors.
I call the bed and breakfast.
Okay. Hello, Brandy and Bay's Mountain B&B. Hi, how can I help you at 2 a.m?
Hi, who am I speaking to?
Hello and welcome to Brandy and Bay's Mountain B&B. I'm Brandy, which most people would be able to deduce. I'm sorry, I'm being short with you. It's 2 a.m, what can I help
so
you with?
I'm so sorry, Brandy, for waking you. I was just wondering if you had any rooms available. I know it's crazy early. I just blew a tire, so my scheduling got all
off.
Oh,
you poor dear.
I mean, I'm really sorry. I know I woke you up, but my timing is completely off, and I should have been to a larger place by now. And I'm just wondering if you have any rooms available.
So it's just you traveling out here all by yourself?
I have a couple friends. They're all asleep, so I'm trying to... They're asleep in the car. I've been driving, and I'm really tired, and I don't really trust them to drive.
So
it's my grandpa's car. So.
Well, Are you?
We could all fit into one room. We could sleep on the floor. It doesn't matter.
I'm sorry, dear. Maybe I didn't make this. Is one of them your spouse and
your
children?
Oh no, these are just my friends. We're on a road trip. We're just on a road trip trying to be adventurous.
Okay. At Brandy and Bay's Mountain B&B, we are a Christian family. I only have 2 rooms available.
I see. There are 2 women and 2 men, and we could do 2 women in one room and 2 men in the other.
2 men are gonna share a bed.
One
in
could
my
sleep
house.
On the floor. One could sleep on the floor. One could have the bed.
Honey, this isn't a Motel 6. This is my house. This is a bed and breakfast. Now, if I'm gonna serve you breakfast in the morning, I'm gonna let you sleep in my beds at night. Well, we have rules here. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, I see.
Now,
you know what? Thank you for your time.
Now, don't go. Don't go. Look, we have 2 rooms available. I'm just saying, as a Christian woman, it would be good for me to assume that a couple staying in my... in my house married.
Yes, married. Yes.
Now, as you know, as a good Christian woman, I can always turn the other cheek and assume.
I see. Yes, married. Well,
So you have 2 women and 2 men in your party, so
that,
two married couples that need a room at 2 in the morning.
If that's what you approve of, then yes.
Yes, oh, that sounds great, lovely. Yes, we do have 2 rooms available.
Oh, wonderful, thank you. How much is the night?
Oh, just $25 a night.
Oh, okay.
It's tough out here.
Okay.
When can I expect you?
How far away are
Wait, you want to ask her?
No.
You don't want to ask her where she lives?
Oh, yeah. Well, where are you?
Oh, I'm on just the edge of town. If you just follow down Main Street at the very end, take a right on East West.
Okay.
We're right there. It's a weird street, I know.
What color is the house?
It's just the big white house that says Brandy and Bay's Mountain B&B.
Perfect. Thank you, Brandy.
I can't wait for you to meet Bay in the morning.
Oh, I can't wait to meet Bay either.
Oh my God.
He's a darling.
Is that her husband?
No, it's my brother.
Oh, great.
Oh, I'm not married. I don't know why.
Okay.
I would have a house to myself. But thank you.
Oh, you do.
Thank you. Okay, we'll see you in a second. Okay, right. So you guys head to the edge of town.
Before we get there, Alara of Nebraska. Alara of Nebraska, I beg of you, sir.
Yes.
Please do not speak.
At all? I
beg of you. I will make sure you have potatoes for all the days. If you do not speak to these people.
Lady Arina, anything I can do to help.
Just quiet. Let's practice. What if they, actually, I have to think through every scenario. Hold on. I take that back, Alara of Nebraska. This woman's going to introduce herself
to you.
As
you're talking in the car. Hello! Hi!
We're there? Oh my God, we're there already.
You just park it right there.
Okay.
Come on in.
Hi. No talking.
No, you can say hello. My name is Alara from Nebraska.
I'm not going to stand outside my daddy all night.
Okay, right.
Come on.
I'm going to say nothing else. So you're really, that's it. Hi.
Hello.
No, hello, my name is Alara from Nebraska.
He's really
from
excited.
From Nebraska, just east of here.
Yes. We're so tired. I know you're probably tired as well.
Can I speak to you on the phone?
Yes.
Yes, you had the sweet voice. So this must be your husband.
Yeah.
And what, yes. Alara of Nebraska, what's, just, should
He's
I call
so,
you Miss Nebraska?
Miss Nebraska's wonderful. He's really tired.
Mr. and Mrs. Nebraska. So I have a room for you upstairs. We'll let you settle in the morning. I know it's late and you guys just need to get
absolutely.
Some sleep.
No. Actually, if it's okay,
you would like to take a bath, there are some nice aroma.
I do feel gross.
Candles and things like
that. Where is that located?
So who is this lovely couple?
I'm Livy.
Livy?
Yeah.
They're married.
I'm Tommy.
Tommy and Livy, okay. Mr. and Mrs.
Merrick. Tommy, Livy, Merrick.
Merrick?
Yeah.
Livy, very kind of awkwardly, like she's putting on a show, like, cuddles up to Cross.
Now. When Bay sees you in the morning, just. He might. Seem a little like he has some questions. We don't see many interracial couples around here.
Oh,
you know, it's fine. We are a very progressive Christian household.
Oh, actually, I'm black.
He's gonna be even more surprised. Even more surprised in the morning.
Let me just hold her face is twitching.
Great, so, we have a room for you just below, just downstairs here. So here's your key, and here's your key. Now, again, you have the candles, and we try to make it a romantic a stay here as possible.
Oh, bath, you said.
Whatever we can say. Now, breakfast is at 8 a.m., and that is non-negotiable.
Oh, right, absolutely.
Non-negotiable.
My grandpa's the same way.
Okay.
He's from Colorado. Never mind, it's fine. I'm so tired.
Shoo! So,
thank you, Brandy.
Pushes you guys up the stairs, and you all, what happens next?
Oh, God. Apparently, we're sharing a room.
Okay.
Do not say anything until we get to the room. I don't want them hearing you talk. It's just.
You're already in the room. It's literally.
Oh, we're in the room?
It's
oh,
right
okay,
there.
We're in the room.
She shoos you upstairs. You go into the rooms. You're now both in your rooms, you guys are upstairs and you guys are downstairs, right on top of each other, and this is an old house, probably from the 1880s. It's charming and it's cute, but every single word that is spoken in any part of this house you can hear clearly.
Is the bathroom, like, adjacent to the rooms? Does each room have its own, like,
There's one bathroom in the house.
Oh, okay.
And it's the upstairs bathroom, and there's all the candles and everything, and all that good stuff.
Livy makes a beeline.
So Livy makes a beeline up for the bathroom, shutting the door before anyone else can get in there. So the two of you now have gone into the room, and yeah.
How big is the bed?
Oh, it's a small bed. It's a full.
How many pillows do we have?
Two.
Are there any extra pillows in the room?
No.
How many blankets do we have?
Two. A sheet and
what
a comforter.
What else is in the room?
What do you think this is?
What else is in the room?
A floor and a wicker chair.
Really?
And a window.
Can you make a bed out
He's
of that
He's making
arm?
Pay.
I don't need to. I'm just gonna grab one of the blankets and one of the pillows and lay on the ground.
So you're leaving. So Nebraska walks up to the bed, grabs the comforter, rips it off the bed and a pillow, and lays on the floor, leaving you with the sheet and the empty bed.
You can sleep on the bed, Lady Arida.
How cool is it?
It's, well, you're outside the mountain town, it's Colorado at night, probably like 50, it's chilly, but it's not cold.
Are there any blankets in the rest of the house?
If you wanted to go snooping around, yes.
Oh, then that's good. She's gonna wake up, she's gonna ask questions. I just sleep in the sheet in the bed.
Okay. It's gonna be a nice, restful 6 hours for you.
After Livy thoroughly enjoys all of the various scented soaps and bubbles and has herself a nice bath and gets all squeaky clean, she puts her old clothes right back on and just heads off to the room. We good?
So, Livia walks into the room and Cross has already kind of positioned himself under the covers with his back turned towards the window, and Livia, without thinking, just runs over, jumps in, gets under the covers, and kind of puts her back against Cross, and like they just fall asleep, and both of them get a really nice sleep. Upstairs, you guys are able to hear in the room next door is Brandy, and you can hear her talking to Bay, who is her brother, but for some reason they're in the same room, and
now you wouldn't believe this, but there's a white girl down there who's black.
What?
I know. That's what I said. But I told them you'd be really excited to meet them in the morning. Oh, you know, I always forget these walls are really thin, and it would be really uncomfortable and weird if they could hear what we're saying.
What?
No, just go to, in the morning, don't say anything weird to the black girl.
There's a black girl here?
No, just, there's a white girl who said she's black. I don't, just act normal.
White black girl?
Just good night. I'll see you in the morning.
So you guys all go to sleep. Erida getting a very rough, very little sleep because she was cold all night. Everyone else slept like a baby. Cross the, yeah?
Yeah, I'm about to say, do I actually sleep?
No, Cross, laying there with his head towards the window, never actually closes his eyes and just stares out the window. For some reason, it's been days since Cross has slept, almost as if the beast that is fueled by him when it releases from him, he is fueled by it when it's inside him. And the closer he gets to the creature, the stranger those kinds of things become. So at 8 a.m., you guys hear a knock on the door. Wake up! Breakfast is ready! I can't wait for you guys to come downstairs and meet Bay!
How delightful.
Come on, chop, 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 chop. Breakfast, breakfast, breakfast!
Oh, breakfast sounds fantastic.
I don't suppose that moratorium on murder has started already.
Yeah, it has.
Oh, darn it.
Get back in there.
Now, I didn't
have... I think we should skip breakfast. Let me just pay and we can just leave.
Excuse me, I'm right here. That's very rude. That is extremely rude.
I'm sorry. We're running so late behind because we weren't planning on staying last night.
What? Honey, it's 8 a.m. Nothing in this town opens till 10 anyway.
Oh, no,
what are
but
you
we're
doing?
We're trying to get north because we're on this trip and we have places to be and because our tire popped.
Okay, well, it's a bed and breakfast.
All right, you're right. Okay.
And you haven't met Bay yet.
Oh, okay.
And I know you still need a little bit more rest, which is fine. After you eat, feel free to rest for a little bit. That's totally okay. You have the room until noon. That is the standard here. So we made you some now, none of you are vegetarians, right?
Nah.
No.
Oh, poor sweetie.
any toast?
I wondered why you look so sickly. Now I get it. Toast.
What did you make?
Well, I made bacon.
Bacon.
And ham. And a sausage gravy.
Okay. Do you have anything else?
Well, the gravy's on biscuits.
Do you have any biscuits by just biscuits?
Without gravy?
Maybe some butter or jam?
Well, I have butter and jam, yeah, but there's gravy on the biscuits.
So all the biscuits have gravy on them?
Well, that's how you do it.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Is there any fruit?
Well, yeah, there's a bowl of fruit if you want to be hungry all day. Yeah, we have a bowl of fruit, that's fine. So, comes right this way, and I'd like you guys to meet my brother, Bay.
Hey, y'all.
Hi, Bay. Nice to meet you.
You're just I'm guessing you're the black-white one?
No. Well, but that's my name.
I don't want to offend you here. Are you the white-black one or the black-white one?
No, my name is...
White African-American.
Oh, no. Black is just my name.
What?
It's my name.
Black is your name?
Yeah.
Oh. Randy got confused. Hi, Black. I'm Bay. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Bay.
And you're just the regular old black guy.
Yes, I am.
Is your name Black as well?
No. It is...
What's your name, good sir?
Tommy Merrick. Black was her maiden name. We're progressive like that.
Oh, her maiden... Oh, you two are hitched. I'm real happy for you. That's real great, you know? How long you guys been married?
Just a couple months now.
Couple months? Still in the honeymoon phase, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Some sort of like honeymoon getaway thing? You guys newlyweds as well?
No.
Miss Nebraska, I heard?
Yes, that's me. Miss Nebraska.
Her grandfather loves him. They're good friends.
Your grandfather, but you're... Okay, all right. I don't really care. I'm just trying to be nice, you know? Cordial conversation over
Absolutely.
Breakfast.
So
what brings you guys to Walton? What brings you out here?
Oh, we're just on a road trip.
As he's talking to you, he's chewing on bacon and just kind of ripping it and...
On a road trip, just as friends do.
What type of breakfast? Is this like, is it kind of like this big bowl of bacon, big bowl of sausage? All right, I'm going to pile up my plate real nice and big.
Is there anything besides everything. Fruit?
And just go to town.
Are there eggs?
Yeah.
I mean, we cook eggs with ham. There's chopped ham in the eggs.
Is there any toast?
Do you just want a piece of bread, ma'am? I'm sorry. I don't mean to judge. You know, Brandy does every once in a while, but I don't really give a shit what you do.
I just want
I'll get you. Don't tell Brandy.
Okay.
Let her do her thing. I'll make you, yeah. So he grabs a couple slices of bread and just takes a stick of a butter knife and puts it in the thing of butter and just slaps a giant thing of butter on there and hands it to you. Vegetarian, I guess. That's kind of weird, you two being hitched and you enjoying that meat like you do and you being vegetarian. I could never.
Opposite.
Sir, I commend you. I could never marry somebody like that. That's.
Opposites attract.
Yeah, opposites attract, apparently.
Yeah, you gotta, like, rework your life to deal with that, right? Like, I guess if she cooks for herself, that's... Well, you don't say much, do you, boy?
He's quiet type.
I guess that's how it works, huh?
Yep.
Okay, guys. You know, that's how it works, I guess. But, so you guys are just in town for travel?
Yeah. What about you? Are you from here?
All of my life.
Did you grow up in this house?
All of my life. With my sister.
Have you ever thought about leaving?
Every day.
Why don't you leave? There's a lot of stuff to see out there.
Well, it's not that easy.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to stir up things.
Brandy, you want to talk to these people? Yes! Sorry, I had to... I was getting some Bloody Marys ready for you guys. You look like you need a little pick-me-up this morning.
The fruit's on the table, right? Oh, mm-hmm. Livy starts putting fruit in front of Arida.
So we have some strawberries and some grapes. I know that's not going to fill you up, but I'm so
perfect.
Sorry.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, but... So after you guys eat, if you want, you can go back upstairs. You know, I don't want to bother you guys too much.
Is it okay if we pay our bill, Sue? Just so we can be out of your hair and, you know, I don't want you to...
Yeah, you can do that all on the internet.
Oh, you want us to just pay online?
Yep, you can go to my website and you can click on a little reservation thing and just say you booked yesterday. It'll try to give you a little runaround.
Is it okay if I give you just cash?
Well, of course.
Oh, okay, perfect.
Yeah.
Okay, wonderful.
You can just leave it in the room when you leave.
Perfect, thank you so
little,
much.
There's a little bowl there and you can put it in the bowl and...
What is the, okay, perfect, thank you.
Yeah. Now, I'm not gonna ask for tips, but...
I was gonna ask you what the custom is around tipping around here.
Well, it, you know, if you're satisfied with your stay, 20% is customary, but you know, 20% on top of 25 is just not that much. It doesn't.
I hear you. And you made this huge breakfast for us.
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
And we woke you up so early.
I know, and I got up 3 hours later to start cooking this wonderful breakfast that you didn't eat.
So you slept for an hour?
$100 for all of us would probably be okay.
That would be wonderful.
Okay,
thank you for that. Do you guys need anything else while you're here? Anything at all before?
By chance, do you have a white book? A phone book, by chance?
Well, yeah, of course.
Yeah, do you mind if I take a look?
Oh, yeah, no, not a problem. So she goes off to the kitchen and comes back with a phone book.
As she leaves, I sneak some sausage bacon under my shawl into my arm.
Bay is sitting there eating bacon, watching you do this. Doesn't seem to care. And comes back and goes, here you go. They put one on my doorstep every 6 months, and I don't. I always say keep it just in case you need it. And Bae's like, you're never gonna need a phone book, but now look, I do, right, Bae?
You know, cell phone reception up here, it's spotty.
It is really spotty. That's what I said. That's what I told him.
But clearly, you like to plan. You're a planner.
Right. Thank you. Right?
Bae just continues eating the bacon, looking at you guys with that long stare. Remembering when you asked him about if he ever thinks about leaving.
If I had a plot point right now, I would bust him out. But alas, I do not.
So she hands you guys the white pages, and you are able to find a John Galushi in Walden.
Okay, I'll write that down. And this should be kind of safe about, I'll flip over some other pages too, just make it look like I'm not looking at a single one.
Okay. And, so you guys need anything else for your stay here?
Do we get coffee?
You get coffee here? Yes, we have coffee. Is that vegetarians drink coffee?
Sometimes.
Okay, just making sure.
Thank you.
So, she leaves you guys to it, and, you're pretty free to rest or whatever until noon, and... Then you've got...
time to kill.
About 6 hours to kill. This is not quite summer yet. You guys are in the early months of the year, so it's about end of March, beginning of April area, so sun still goes down around 7
p.m. Are there any stores to buy, like, hair dye or something of that nature? I'm thinking that we should change you guys' looks up a bit. Go in disguise mode.
I suppose you got a point there. Get some shears for Nebraska right there.
Yes.
So, the group leaves the Brandy and Bay's Mountain B&B at noon as they're leaving. Bye! Thank you guys so much!
Bye, thank you!
No, don't forget about Yelp!
All right,
stars, Yelp, right?
Yes. Yes, thank you! Thank you, thank you! Tell everyone how progressive we were!
Bye, bye, bye.
So you guys leave and head towards the local grocery store, which has a small collection of random household items you would need. Hair dye, things like that, clippers.
What color do you want your hair to be?
Oh, I'm thinking Livy's gonna stay in the car and avoid security cameras.
Right, but like, I ask you before I go.
Red's nice.
Red, okay. Gentlemen?
Just get shears and scissors.
Shears and scissors. You want to do hair dye? Okay.
Yes, because that would be
I
really
color my hair?
You can.
She
we'd go darker?
Could it be blue?
I don't know if they're gonna have blue here.
That sounds amazing.
I think we're gonna have to go with more like brown, black.
Whatever you think is best.
Red.
Red, I like the sound of that.
Red earth. So I buy some shears and I grab a couple different hair dye kits.
Okay. You guys make your way out back where you've parked your car on the backside of this grocery store where there was a stray electrical cord run for probably a leaf blower or something like that. You open up the shears and I'm going to use a plot point. And Nebraska grabs the shears, seeing these before when they use these on sheep at one of the farms he worked at. He goes, I know how to disguise myself, and immediately starts cutting all of his hair.
Well, I'm gonna use a plot point. Can I use a plot point to counter that? In a very real sense, I have not thought those shears are for me. I thought he got those. I have no interest in cutting my hair. This was the only form of like expression I had as a slave. So that's important to me.
Okay.
I'm not allowing anybody to change the amount of hair I have and what I've done to it. Color is cool to me because it's choice.
Do you have a,
But I don't mind using that plot point to instead say I pick up the shears because I haven't seen electric shears before. I turn them on.
Now let's see, before we do that, do you have a D6?
I do.
Roll that D6.
Six.
I have five, you son of a bitch. So, he does not cut his hair.
It's my brand.
He does not cut his hair, but instead cuts his finger wide open, playing with the shears.
Oh, jeez.
That's what guards are for.
Here, give that to Cross. I'll bandage him up.
Take 1 point of damage off your armor.
I did buy ponytails though, so you're gonna be wearing a man bun, probably.
I don't know what a man bun? That sounds delicious.
I put his hair up in a bun.
Okay, so his hair is now up in a tall bun. Doesn't do much to disguise him, given he still looks like a Viking.
We're gonna go dye his hair, but we need to find a place to dye it.
You're gonna have to do that here in the parking lot.
We're doing it in the parking lot?
Yeah.
All right,
can we do it? Do I see anything? Can we just hold on to it for the next time that we find ourselves in some ridiculous motel situation?
What if somebody...
I mean, you've got 6 hours to kill.
All right.
Just gonna dye our hair in broad daylight in the parking lot.
All right.
Are there any hotels open? We can go get another hotel.
We were just...
That was the only one.
Oh my gosh. We can't go back.
We can buy a lot of bottled water and go out to the boonies somewhere.
I mean, it's the back of a grocery store in a small town of a population of 600 people. I don't think that you need to be too worried.
Okay. Yes.
All right, let's just do it.
All right. This stuff stinks.
What color do you want your hair to be?
Black, brown, red.
Red.
Two redheads, all right.
Okay, who else is changing their appearance?
I'm gonna start shaving my head a little bit.
So you're gonna shave your head?
Yep.
Are you going to lose the facial hair? Because that's the most defining aspect.
Yep, I'm going back to... God, I can't even do the police stash anymore. I'm going to have to go clean and shaving, aren't I?
Okay, so you're shaving?
Yeah.
And what are you doing?
Dyeing my hair red.
Dyeing your hair red? You're dyeing your hair red?
Yeah.
And...
Oh, I don't need
anything. And since they're not looking for you, are you going to do anything with your facial hair to make it slightly different?
I guess hair is hair. I'm going to, without kind of thinking, just add that to the what's being dyed.
Dye. All right, can everybody roll intellect?
That's fair. No, that's fair.
14.
Ugh. Oh.
No. That's not good. That's 6.
Okay. Almost as if majestically, an hour later, everyone removes all of the coloration from their hair and, you know, kind of all comes together again to look at each other. And Nebraska here, like Vivelle Sassoon, shakes his hair and it's a bright, vibrant red. And his beard is now a very colorful, bright, and fiery fire engine red.
Doesn't do much to disguise him from looking like the same guy that's on television, other than looking a little bit more well kept than
before. I like it.
Livia looks down at her hands, and it's a, like the hair in her hands is like a bleached, washed kind of mix of brown and orange and red splotches. But she's like, yeah, whatever. And Cross has got a mangled head with weird spots and patches and everything. These were grocery store kind of clippers that ended up leaving a lot of like pulled hair, and you've got little like tissue paper blood spot things all over your face and the top of your head from trying to shave all of it.
Well, this was
one of our better ideas.
Not maybe the best.
What time is it when this is all over?
You know, we're around 3 in the afternoon. You guys get back in the caravan, leaving the grocery store without any masks or black clothing whatsoever for some reason, and make your way back into
red hair.
But your hair is a different color, so that's great.
And pen writer.
I can't wait for a year from now when you guys are like all really experienced at infiltrating and things, and all these things are thought of. It's gonna be awesome. But for now, you guys make your way up the hill, and the small town of 600 people, and you can see about a mile outside of town on a hill on the side of a mountain, a giant mansion, way up on the distant mountainside there. As the sun sets, you guys park the car and start walking your way up the mountain. About 200 yards before you get to the house, there is a security gate up ahead, which does have a security camera on it. You can see, and how do you proceed?
How tall is the gate, by chance? I'm just curious.
It's about a 12-foot tall gate.
So it was twice the size of the previous gate.
Goes around the whole property, presumably?
No. There's, if you walk to the left, there is like a mountain kind of ridge that you would, if you were determined, you'd be able to kind of get up and inside.
Climb it, but it's not a pathway.
It's not a pathway.
But on the right, it's just fence?
Yeah. Or an even steeper mountainside.
All right, you guys. What's the plan then? How are you guys gonna get in?
We'll have to go around some way. Okay. You can go straight in, though.
I'm just wondering.
Just keep them talking. Try to get as much information on your father and PRS as possible. Or at least slip in as much as you can. If you say, I don't know, cucumber sandwich, we know the bug out.
Cucumber sandwich.
If you ever have a normal conversation with cucumber sandwich in it, then...
I actually have had normal conversations, but that's neither here nor there. Cucumber sandwich. And you guys will do the bird call, and you guys are leaving.
So we're keeping the phone line open. Is that how?
As long
hearing?
As we can. Yep.
Okay.
Probably been a good idea to buy two ways.
So you're gonna keep the. She's gonna keep the phone in her pocket, calling you on, and you're having the other end.
Yeah.
Make sure your end is on mute, so I don't hear you.
Somebody's end would have to not be on mute for them to hear.
Your end has
to not. If our end is on mute, then we're not transmitting any sound.
Yeah.
Oh, then mine will be on mute.
Yours shouldn't be on mute. We want to be able to hear what you say.
Yeah, I was right. Okay.
Yes.
So make sure. Yeah. Yeah. So make sure it's on mute.
Yes.
You're a master infiltrator.
Shh. I'm gonna leave all that up to you guys.
This is gonna go so smoothly.
It's gonna go.
I can tell.
So well.
Erida makes her way by herself up to the very tall, looming gate. As she walks up, there's a small keypad and a camera up above, and the keypad has a little speaker on it. You dial in.
Yes.
Okay. Hello.
Hello?
Yes?
Hi. Belushi?
Who's asking?
You probably don't remember me, but you knew my father. I was hoping I could talk to you about him. It's Erida.
Who's your father?
William?
William.
Yeah.
And you're Erida.
Yeah. It's been a long time since I've last seen you. Probably not since I was a little girl. So I might look a little different.
And you just come up here in the middle of the night?
Yeah, I was at my grandpa's place and started talking and I just couldn't get off my mind, so I got a crazy whim to just drive up here. I mean, you remember my grandfather, I'm sure. Just down south.
Yeah, prickly old bastard.
He's charming in his own way. He's just, he's a little prickly. He's very lovely once you get to know him.
You alone?
Yes.
Where's your car?
I left it down the street.
Why? You could drive right up through my driveway.
Oh, it's very intimidating. You have a very big house.
Well, I do try. Stand back. And you step back and the gate opens up, allowing you to walk up to the front of the house. Arda!
Hi!
You have grown.
Yes, I have.
Wow.
Not creepy at all.
I remember when you were just this big, giving you candy.
I remember.
Would you like some candy?
I love candy, sure. It'd be wonderful. It's one of my favorite memories.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
So, Belushi waves for you to come inside, and the door closes. You guys can see as Erida walks in, and the door closes behind her. Now, the gate is slowly closing. Do you run through the gate or try to go around the other side?
Is the camera still pointing directly in front of the gate?
Mm-hmm.
But he's... Well, one presumes he has security. Okay, whatever you guys want to do.
I'm thinking, especially after the Judy debacle, Nebraska's gonna be mostly just kind of following suit for most of this. All eyes on you, Thomas Detective Cross.
All right, well, I'm gonna just skirt wide of it. I'm gonna start looking at bars around the gate, see if any of them are kind of worn out, if they show empires, or if he's a guy who's really taking security seriously, whereas like brand new gates.
Brand new everything.
So are we doing the hill thing?
We can try that, or we could... How sharp does your arm get?
How sharp do you need it to be?
So, just throwing it out there, I mean, I know that I kind of like to destroy things, but also we could go into the back maybe, and I could maybe make a hole?
You are very good at putting holes in things.
Unless Detective Cross thinks that that's a bad idea. I'm sometimes a poor judge of that.
I think it's a dangerous idea, but we've trained a little bit, so maybe it'll be okay.
Does that mean it's gonna hit me in the back of the head?
We'll walk you through it.
Can you go ahead and roll your power and an action for me?
Sure. Oh, and action. Nine.
Okay, so we go back inside now to Erida, who has been given a bowl filled with candies that are unwrapped, just a bowl of unwrapped candies that you are holding out in front of you. So, Erida, what brings you to my neck of the woods?
I'd like to assess my surroundings.
As you are talking, you see over his shoulder, off in the distance, a flash of light. And you hear, about 20 feet outside the window, a cling, cling, as the gate that she has teleported away from the outside, like kind of falls in visual, like you see kind of the flash as the metal falls and you hear a cling, cling.
Okay. Can I use a plot point?
Yes.
To revise that slightly?
Okay.
So, there is a flash of light, however, focusing and remembering her earlier training montage with Thomas Detective Cross, she is able to direct the chunk of fence back further, like towards the hill area that's behind them, outside of the gate area, where they maybe
won't. So here's how we're going to say how that happens. So as she teleports with her left hand and sees it start falling through the air towards the house, and you see the flashlight and see it coming down, she quickly looks over to her left and then shoots with her right hand, grabbing it out of the air as it's falling and taking it, teleporting it across the other side of the mountain.
And then feels like a bad.
Am I okay? Is it done?
You're okay.
Oh, all right. You were saying?
Oh, yeah, yes.
You seem to have.
Sorry.
Something startled you.
This music is wonderful, by the way. You just have this playing?
Yes, I'm a stereotypical Scotchman.
I love it. Yeah. I don't remember the music from when I was a child.
What do you think of my kilt?
You're very dashing.
The air. Sorry, more candy.
This is a lot of candy. I think I'm good for a while. Thank you. So, I know I haven't seen you in a long time, the Lucy Bet, sir.
Yes, your father.
Yes, but I was hoping to just talk to you about him a bit. I mean, we didn't really have a chance to talk, him and I, before he passed. So, I'm just questioning a lot of things. I'm missing him and wondering what.
Yes.
You know, there's a lot of unanswered questions.
Aye.
And I know that you guys spent a lot of time together and worked together.
Aye, we did. He spoke very highly of you.
Really?
Very.
When was that?
Well, all the time.
That's interesting. Wouldn't have guessed that.
Well, you know. What do you know about your father?
Well, until recently, not very much.
As he says this, and he drinks some scotch in his kilt with his bagpipes playing behind him. You can tell that he's prying a little bit to see, to gauge whether or not you know about your father's involvement and what he actually did for a living. Because as far as you guys know, he was a used car salesman. Well, we go back outside to our three infiltrators that have now crossed through the gate and have started making their way up the back side of the house along the mountain side. So the house is to your east, and you guys are on the west side.
I'm gonna keep looking out for other security cameras as we're walking.
Okay. Roll intellect for me.
Sure. That's 11.
There's none that you can see.
Oh, just in case, just keep two shadows close to the building as much as possible.
Are there any open windows?
You wouldn't be able to tell from this distance.
Oh, okay.
So you guys just keep making your way up the west side,
yep.
Moving towards the back of the house.
Yep, you're using as much cover as possible, yeah. Just in case.
Okay.
Right.
In the clear for now. So, what do you know of your father?
Well, I recently have learned that he was in the PRS, presumably with you. Which is new information to me.
Oh, your grandfather.
Grandpa might have
closed
a few things.
You know, that was a different time.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm not really with the PRS anymore.
When did you quit?
Oh, years back. That bastard Kozel. Kozel took over. Keep the rest of us out. But it's neither here nor there. What do you want to know about your father?
How long was he in the PRS?
Long time.
What is that? Like, my whole life?
Why are you so curious?
Well, when you grow up thinking your dad's a used car salesman, and then you see this connection of the name that's been appearing in newspapers, it's just nobody really knows anything about it. I mean, you can see why a girl might wonder who her dad really was.
Right. Well, he was a good agent.
Did he work for you a long time?
As you're saying that, a small dog runs from the back of the house out to his front. Oh, Fluffy!
Aww.
Fluffy comes to say hello. Look at her new front. So Fluffy is a small Pomeranian dog that starts getting really excited as it comes up close to you, but then starts barking constantly and moving towards the front door and barking. Oh, Fluffy's gotta take a piss real quick. Hold on. Just kind of opens the door and lets Fluffy out and closes the door again. He'll come back when he's done. So, your father. We go now to you guys outside who have a, you hear come out that you see the front door kind of open and it's light over there, so you can see a small white dog come outside and kind of move about 10 feet out into the front, quickly piss, and look directly towards you all off in the distance, kind of looking.
Don't.
I just freeze.
Very slowly move over there.
So we're just gonna slowly continue to
and this
the second you take a step, the dog starts barking and runs over towards you guys. Can all three of you roll charisma?
Does anybody have animal handling?
No.
Well, actually, no.
16.
11.
16.
Oh, good job. So it starts barking and running up right next to you guys and barks a couple times and then just starts and excited to see three new friends outside here.
So glad we had a big breakfast.
Yeah. Livy just kind of scratches a little puppy on its little tiny head. It's so adorable. Okay. I guess we'll just let it trail or whatever.
So you guys start making your way back on the west side of the house, heading towards the back, and the dog is now right there with you every once in a while, giving a little bark and just moving along with you, trying and then kind of barking and then running a little bit towards the house and then back and running towards the house and then back, as if trying to invite you guys in to come, come play.
Small beast.
Do I hear the barking?
Yeah, you hear the barking and. Probably a squirrel.
Should we call probably Fluffy? Squirrel. Should we call Fluffy back in? I love dogs. I love to cuddle with Fluffy.
See you.
No, it's...
Do you have any other animals? Do you have any cats? I'm sorry. I'm nervous. I haven't seen you in a long time.
Nervous? Why are you nervous?
Because I haven't seen you since I was a child, and I'm asking about a job I didn't know you even had. I thought you guys sold old Buicks. Not doing missions and things.
Well, what do you know about Pyaris?
I know that they're hired agents to take care of Psyots. And that it's run by the government. That's basically it.
What makes you say Psyots?
That seems to be the trend these days.
But, I mean, your father.
He hated people like that.
I mean, what did any of us know about Psyots back then?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, Psyots were really not even known about until recently.
All I know is that he hated anybody that was different than him, especially people that had special abilities.
Sound like the man I know.
Really?
No.
I'm very confused then.
Waves kind of... Would you like some scotch?
Sure.
Really?
Yeah.
Seem...
I would love some scotch.
Seem tense.
I take...
It's good with the candy.
I've never actually had scotch before.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. I kind of smell it. I'm like, you know what?
Have a seat.
This smells very strong. I don't know if I'm ready for it yet.
Have a seat.
I sit down.
Dumb dog. He turns around and opens the front door. Fluffy? 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 That's a very goddamn dog.
fine. So, your father.
Yeah.
He's a good man. May not have shown it. Everything he did for you. You and your mother.
I wasn't around very often.
That's my fault. See, that's what I did. It was my job. Your father worked for me.
Doing what?
Why are you really here? So on that note, we cut back out to you guys, who've now made it to the back of the house with Fluffy still in tow. You've come now to the back where you can see a small shed and a carport. A couple cars, the driveway had looped around the house. And you can see like the back area where you can see a kitchen. Kind of on the left facing side of the house. On the right side, there's a study.
So are we still on the west side, or are we?
You've come around to the back, to the north side of the house.
How many of those rooms have exterior doors?
Towards the outside, just the kitchen.
Okay.
By chance, while I was looking at the walls of the door, was there anything that looked like a security system on it? Like a power box for that? Like the standard, like, Briggs or, you know.
When he was opening the door and
closing it? Opening door, just anything like that. Like, if I, like, broke a lock or anything like that, something that would trip it.
And yes.
There is something like that.
Mm-hmm. Any open windows?
There are windows. None of them are open.
Is there a dog door?
Mm-hmm.
How big is the dog door?
Very clever. Clever girl.
It's the size of a Pomeranian.
I take back my lesson.
It's big enough for a tiny Livy to maybe squeeze through?
You know what's gonna happen next.
Come on, Mom, don't do it.
Oh, we're gonna get stuck.
Can you roll for intellect?
It's gonna happen.
I'm just glad it's not me.
I would love a plot point right about now, I'm just saying. Nine.
So, Livia, seeing the small doggy door, looks at Detective Cross and Nebraska and is like, I got this. And runs forward and tries to fit her head into the doggy door, getting just about to her shoulders. And she is now stuck, and the dog is behind her, barking at her, trying to get through.
Sorry, I wasn't able to get, like, even an arm through?
Just your head. Mm. It's a Pomeranian. You're up to, like, about here. And if you try to go back, it's kind of...
Nebraska, pull her out.
How stuck?
Watch my head.
How do you get stuck in a rectangle with your head? I guess do we try?
We have to pull her out.
Continue barking incessantly. God damn dog. What? Apologize. Opens the front door. Fluffy!
We gotta pull her!
I'm sorry. Sounds like the dog's had some bit of a accident in the back, so. One moment.
Where's the candy? Yep. Bowl of candy?
The bowl of candy's still, like, kind of right there in your lap, in your hands, and...
I stand up and drop it and break it. I'm so sorry. I was coming to help you, and I totally spaced, and I dropped all this candy.
No, that's...
And was that crystal? It looked really expensive. I'm so sorry.
Everything's expensive.
I know, I'm really nervous about touching anything.
Come on. So he bends down and he starts picking up the candies.
I'm just so clumsy. I'm
just
so
like
sorry.
A girl.
I know. I always drop
the candy.
Always dropping it.
We go back out to you guys.
Was that something breaking? Lady Arda might be in trouble.
No. Pull. Genius.
Okay.
Just help me get back.
So we grab.
Same
I guess
time.
We each grab an arm and a leg.
Yes.
And we pull at the same time.
And you guys pull at the same time. Can all three of you roll for might?
So much.
12.
Okay. Oh, I thought you. Never mind. No. You rolled my luck. I was like, yes.
20.
I don't even know what looking at is.
Oh, pretty much. It's
you guys, Nebraska being on your left side, grabs with his right arm and Cross with his left, and they both pull, and when they pull, they pull so hard that you go flying across the carport, landing into the trash cans, ripping out the doggy door as it's connected to the top of your head.
All right, how much of a hole is left?
Well, it ripped a little bit of the wood of where, because it was just tiny little screws holding the doggy door on.
So mostly still just
like there's still like a box where it was, but it ripped it out, and there's now a little thing. You guys not realizing your own strength, especially Nebraska, as you're picking up.
Is our theme music now?
As you guys are picking up the candy, you hear a crash into the trash cans.
Where am I now?
Just down on the ground picking up the candy with Galushi. Fucking raccoons.
Yes. Damn. Oh, those raccoons are the worst.
Would it offend you if I grab my my rifle and...
Oh, you know...
The dog will bark all night.
I think we should
kill that goddamn raccoon.
No, it probably wasn't a raccoon. I'm sure of it.
What?
I actually don't know. I'm sorry.
We get raccooned all the time.
You know, could I wait till morning? I'm sure Fluffy. I don't like
as you're, saying that, the dog comes running into the room with a small chip of wood in its mouth, chewing it, just looks right up at you guys. Like, oh, well, I guess you're right. The raccoons are gone, and this little shit probably got into my woodshed. Okay, well, Gandhi's fine. We're okay. So, back to what we were saying.
Yes, so you were telling me that my father was a good man who worked for you.
Hold on.
Okay.
He dumps a whole bunch more candy into the bowl and hands you a new bowl.
Where are you? Candy. A new bowl and new candy.
Well, there's a bowl next to the door, and there's candy in the, like, stand next to the door, of course. Where do old people keep their candy?
I have a question. Is it Werther's original candy?
No.
Damn.
No.
These are probably, like, the old ones. The ones that are, like, the shiny ones with stripes and colors, I'm assuming.
That,
like,
you try to take one. It's a bag of candy that he rips open and dumps into it, so it's all unwrapped now.
It's those ones that have been at your dentist's office since, like, 1968. Like, nobody's touched them. It's like that.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay. So about my father, can you please tell me just any more information about him? You say he was a good man, but it's just, look, I know that he wasn't actually a used car salesman. I just pretended that I believed that because my mom would constantly say it. But as far as I knew growing up, he was always getting into trouble of some sort. Some might call it like he was a con man. I don't know any details, though.
Just a good agent. He's a good man, a good agent. I can't... I would have let it go. Just... The less you know about what he did, the better.
How long was he in the PRS? Was it until he died? Did he serve that long?
Yes. Your whole life. A long time. Look, I'm a little worried that you come all the way out here to ask me these questions. Could have been answered on the phone.
I like talking in person. You could have just hung up on me.
Admirable. Fishy. Why now?
Versus.
He's been dead for 4 years.
Listen, my father and I didn't have the best of relationship towards the end of his life. And I've been trying to not think about it. But then recent discoveries, I can't ignore it any longer.
Okay. What are you three doing?
I'm gonna use a plot point.
Okay.
Oh,
And my arm, I'm gonna snake my arm down through the dog door and then up to grab and open the door from inside.
Hold up, wait. As I see it, I was like, wait a second, don't open it yet. Just, can you just expand your hand as much as you can? Cover, do you feel metal in there?
I do.
Just keep spreading it. Remember what happened to the cell phone?
No.
Oh wait, no, I don't actually know that either. Yeah, shit, nope, never mind.
Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna.
But that doesn't. I mean, you could still tell him to expand the armor for the metal part.
I just expand it through metal. Like these things are pressure sensitive. Okay. I can break the lock pretty easily. The problem is that as soon as it opens, if the alarm is on, it's gonna trip something. So if you can get your fingers like just into the distant crevices and hold there, and as much pressure you can, as if it's still closed.
Okay, so.
I guess then. So instead of grabbing the handle, I will just send my arm up and sort of just spread my hand out along the wall, which just will allow my arm to zap, I guess.
So Nebraska's arm snakes through the opening in the dog hole, and you see it kind of slithering its way out in all directions, latching itself around the cold metal parts until it gets up to a small metal box in the top right corner of the door where you see a little tss and a spark, and you hear the door unlatch, much to your surprise.
That was way easier than I thought it was going to be.
Pound it. Gently.
So, the kitchen door is now kind of moving its way open as Fluffy kind of happily works its way back to you guys, just wagging its head, looking at you as if it's time to play.
Hey, we gotta get away from this door.
Can't have the dog following us. Livia, can you just stay here with the dog and try to look out for us? Make sure if he moves, let us know.
You want me to stay here and play with the dog?
I want you to be a lookout. Like, we don't all need to go, and if it follows all of us, then he's gonna come looking sooner or later. Worst comes to worst, you can lead him outside and chase him around.
Okay.
Dog starts getting agitated as you guys just stand in the doorway.
Livy is going to look around the kitchen for something that looks like dog treats. And so that she can feed the dog to try and shut the dog up.
Okay, roll for intellect.
I'm gonna feed this dog a banana, aren't I?
Some dogs might like that.
15.
Okay. You see over on the windowsill above the kitchen sink a small glass jar filled with little doggy treats. And you go over and grab one and get his attention with it.
Just feeding little dogs. I'm gonna. Livy sits down, hunkers down in the kitchen and just starts feeding the dog bits of the bone and petting it and trying to soothe it. Go, go, go.
Okay, so. Alright. And where do you guys head?
I'm following Cross's leap.
I'm just looking from the window. I'm looking for a study or a computer room.
The study would be just to your right of when you've come in the kitchen. If you were to go straight down the hallway, it would lead you towards the front of the house. But if you take a sharp right, it leads towards the study.
Yeah, I'm gonna make a sharp right and hope to all God he's like one of them old school people who like it in file cabinets instead of a computer.
Well, you make your way down the hallway. Now this is an old house with wood floors. So as you're walking, you hear feet start to.
I'm gonna listen on the. Who has the cell phone, by the way?
She does.
Oh no, which one of us has the receiver in?
Lydia with the burners, yeah. Oh yeah, we don't have that.
Yep. Alright, gonna have to go as slowly as possible.
Yep. Just that slight.
Yep, real slow.
Can I hear that?
You barely hear the creaking of the floor in the distance, and because you're looking for sounds, you notice it.
Okay.
But to your knowledge, Belushi does not. So, why now?
Again, I told you. I get into my backpack, and I start. Just one second, I have something in here I want to show you.
Are you okay? Got me. Thoughts in your throat?
Oh, maybe. Too many sweets.
Do you need me to get behind you if I press?
Okay, hold on.
Are you? You're okay.
Yes, thank you.
Sometimes I just get uncontrollable coughs. So it's annoying. And I pull him out of my backpack. I kept the little box. And I like pull out the card with my dad's ID saying PRS, like, you know, and I show it to him like,
ah,
yes. So
you found this and went hunting.
Yes.
Understandable. It's good to know where someone came from. What leads them to where they are now. Okay. Well, I don't.
Sorry.
We cut back to you guys in the hallway. Making your way. You're now to the door to the study, which is closed, but is not locked.
I'm going to open it very slowly. Really? Does it open any fast and make it any less noise or just so squeaky?
It'll be just a quick.
I'm just pushing it open as fast as I can.
Okay.
You look for clues. I'll watch.
Sure.
Because I can't look for clues. I guess I'd stand by the door, basically, and just keep a lookout.
Okay.
I'm going to go in. Is there any file cabinets by chance, or is it just a computer?
There is a computer and two filing cabinets. It's a small laptop, folded, closed, on the desk, in the center of the room. And two filing cabinets behind the desk on the back left side.
I'm gonna start with the filing cabinets, and I'm gonna try to first just open them, see if they're locked.
Okay, they are both locked.
All right, I'm gonna actually try to pick them.
Okay, you do have that lock picking kit in your. Go ahead and roll an action for me.
Okay, action. Just raw action or with the
action D12? With the D12.
Okay. Six.
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 As you are working on the top filing cabinet, you get in there and you give it a turn a little too hard, snaps the filing cabinet lockpick, leaving half of it inside, unable to be pulled out.
You're kidding me, right? No, you're not. Okay, then. I'm going to do a quick look on the desk to see if there's any paper opener or anything that locks. Screw, but maybe I can open the other one.
Okay, so Cross starts filing through the desks quickly and quietly, and he sees that there's the top drawer is locked, but it's a very old desk with a very simple just latch kind of thing, so he just slides the back end of a file inside there, unlocking it, and there's a set of two keys inside there.
Of course. All right, I'm gonna take the keys out, and I'm gonna go to the unjammed lock.
Okay, the bottom shelf?
Yep. Yeah. And yeah, open up and see if there's any labeling for anything that is related to either Idaho or PRS.
So as you open it up, can you go ahead and roll intellect for me?
Sure, okay. That's a bad score. 16.
Okay. You open up the filing cabinet and inside you see hundreds of files all labeled in alphabetical order. Just going down the line, not in names of cities or places or anything like that, but mission names. Just down the line.
Is there anything that... no city names. Do I remember offhand what the name of the hospital was?
No.
Alright, I'm gonna... And I didn't bring a freaking backpack with me. I'm gonna just start picking ones at random and seeing if they have any sort of logical grouping. So if the naming scheme corresponds with the location or mission parameter, and just seeing if I can see a pattern.
Okay, so Detective Cross, you're looking through all the folders?
Yeah.
You're looking through the folders, and we go now back to the conversation. Livia's still in the kitchen playing with the dog. So, I don't know what I can tell you about your father. I can't reveal any mission briefings. I can't do it.
You don't work for PRS anymore, though.
No, but... with the internet these days and you being a very smart girl, I can't tell you these things and give it out to the public. come back to haunt me?
I'm not gonna make it public information. I just need to know some things.
Can you be more specific?
I don't understand what my father's involvement was, or how these agents are found, how he got involved, where, how do they recruit people?
Yeah.
Hi. Where do they have locations? Is that why he was never home? Because he was always at, like, living somewhere else? Are there bases everywhere? And no families are allowed? Like, all these questions.
Look. You get out of the military. You go. You try out. It's we look for people like your father. We look for them. He's a ideal candidate.
What does that mean? There's a lot of people who leave the military.
Your father had was very skilled with a rifle. Earned his marks overseas. Needed work. We provide the work, or we did. Where's that dumb dog? Fluffy? God damn it.
I'm sure.
This is all making me a little anxious. I'm gonna grab myself a cup of milk.
Are you sure you want some milk? I mean, we have scotch right here. I start kind of saying it really loud. Are you sure you want milk? Like, you have amazing scotch.
You are very strange, Arda. I'm gonna grab some milk. So
I get like really nervous and like trip on purpose over a chair. Blah!
You're so good at this.
Well, heard that.
Would you like me to grab you an ice pack while I'm in the fridge?
Don't you?
No, it's fine. I'll grab you an ice pack.
I'm.
It's okay.
I just need your help. Getting up.
It's.
Okay, I guess I'll just be in here falling down while you go to the kitchen.
Don't you have the phone?
Yeah.
So.
I don't know that.
When she starts to make his way down the hallway towards the kitchen, you heard that he was headed that way.
So is there only one exit out of the kitchen? There's only one door?
Well, there's pretty much the hallway that would definitely put you in eyeline of him, but the door is also an eyeline of the hallway.
Oh no.
The broken
okay.
door.
Is there a pantry?
Yeah.
But he's gonna see the
he's gonna see the back door no matter what I do.
Yeah, you're not getting around that.
So,
okay. So Olivia, genius intellect, is going to kind of try and rile up the dog and like push it towards the open door. Maybe it'll intercept him, give him some time while she tries to find some freaking cover, hide, whatever.
So, as he's walking down the hallway, now.
No, she's doing this out of sight of the doorway. You said.
No, I know, but you just caught.
Yeah, because emergency, over.
So as he's walking down the hallway, he hears obviously something coming from the kitchen with a caw. Whoa, Fluffy, and. Makes his way across down the hallway, not looking to the left down the other side because his attention is drawn onto the hallway. He moves around the corner and looks over kind of the shelf blocking and sees Fluffy sitting next to the sink looking up at him kind of calmly and he's got a bunch of treats on the like little chewed up treats on the ground like crumbs next to him and he looks up and he sees that the like top of the glass jar is kind of open a little bit and not completely sealed shut. And then he follows his eye line over to the kitchen door, which is open and the doggy door is gone. Oh. Huh.
Did we hear the caw from the study?
Yeah, you guys heard the caw. Everyone heard the caw.
Okay.
As he's looking around the kitchen, let's go back to you guys.
I found nothing, I'm assuming.
It's her caw. Well, you found a ton of files.
Yeah, I'm going to just take the close laptop then and take that, unplug it.
Thomas is across, we need to go. We have heard shattering, choking, pounding, screaming, and now Livia's caca. They definitely need our help. I believe Andy Herda is in a lot of trouble.
So you're saying all this to him into the room. Where do you guys go?
Is there a door? Is there a way for us to skirt around the hallway?
He's kind of at the edge, so if you were to come toward, you would kind of, he's looking into the kitchen, but if you were to come down the hall, you would meet him right there.
Yeah, I think we should. I'm thinking these two women that I left behind are in danger. So I'm gonna go to the screaming that I've heard from the two women that I left behind.
You stop. So,
I'm not gonna take no for an answer. I'm sorry. These women are in trouble, I think.
Nelson, you've got no plot points left.
Sorry.
Nebraska.
I'm really sorry.
Nebraska, hearing the cries for help and the emergency, turns out the door and starts running directly towards, towards Galushi.
I'm walking towards noise. And
you heard the caca, and you're coming up.
Yes. And do I see them?
Not yet. About this, it's all going to happen at once. You get one quick action here.
Oh, what do I see around me? Is there anything in particular? Are there photos? Assessing my dad that I could, see if they're close? I don't know exactly how close they were.
No, there's definitely no pictures of your father in the house.
Okay. Any books or...
It's mainly just pictures of him hunting, large game.
Oh, of course. Uh-huh. Any, day timers or anything that I could, sneak really quick while he's gone into my backpack?
Any day...
Does he have a day planner?
Like a day planner? Not in that room.
Okay. All right, so I leave the room. I follow...
So you're kind of following him into the kitchen?
Yeah, because I'm like, oh my god. And I'm just kind of not sure what to prepare for yet, so...
So as, Erida starts moving behind him down the, hearing the cacao, working down the kitchen. Yeah. She motions behind it, which allows Galushi to turn towards where the noise of her yelling for him to, and now sees Nebraska running.
No! Sorry, guys.
Can you roll an action for me? Roll an action with the D12.
And I can only see him. I can't see much else.
No, it's like a hallway.
Okay. Luck!
So, as Galushi turns and sees you, his eyes kind of go wide, and he takes his scotch and kind of throws it in your face, and it just hits you, and you just barrel into him, taking him to the ground.
Good God, what the... What are you doing? What is going on here? What is happening?
So, I tackle him. At this point, can I, now see Erida and Livia?
Erida runs up on you and Galushi on the ground, and standing over the top of you, and Erida kind of pops her head out from the pantry that she was hiding in. Livia pops her head out of the pantry she was hiding
Erida,
in.
You're both okay. I heard screaming and so
what
I'm just gonna, off of him and just sort of sit back and look down and be like,
who is this mouth?
Everyone just calm down.
What is happening?
Galushi, we need to talk.
Get the smelly fucking beast off of
me. And I get off of him and just sort of sheepishly try to stand behind Erida. I fucked up again. I'm hiding behind Mom.
So Galushi's still kind of on the ground, at least sits up and kind of dusts off his robe, his night robe, and looking up at you. Erida, what is this?
I'm desperate for information.
Wait. You. I know you. And you. I'm guessing there's another one.
Yes.
Come on out! Look, I'm obviously at a disadvantage here. Just come on out.
Cross, come on out.
No one here. I just walk out with this one hand is like...
Yes,
this is what my life has become.
You should be embarrassed. You're...
caveman here just tackle me. What do you want?
I told you I'm looking for information on PRS. We're Whoa. Desperate.
You bring three wanted fugitives into my house.
They shouldn't be wanted fugitives, first of all. They have not done nothing wrong. Well, they've done a few things wrong. But...
it's all over the news.
That the news has actually portrayed it incorrectly, because I happened to be there when it happened. I know, it's strange. That. I was there, I saw it. And they, the PRS were trying to, sorry, Alara? PRS was trying to kill them. And I've...
You four have thwarted PRS for a week.
Yes.
The four of you.
I don't know how we've done it, actually. I'm pretty surprised myself.
My God, this is embarrassing.
I'm just gonna...
This...
What? It's been a wild week. I have not fully come around emotionally and thought about it. I don't want to. I'm not ready for that.
The four of you.
After looking at him for a minute now that I've sort of calmed down, I'm gonna point down and go, do men commonly wear skirts in this land?
Alara.
That looks comfortable.
Oh, well, we could get you one if you want it.
I do.
You're so cute.
A kilt?
Go wipe the fucking scotch off your face. No.
Just gonna do it right here. Okay, now I'm done.
Okay, well. Alright. What do you need? The four of you. You. I don't care. You have embarrassed Kozel. Kozel, the fucking twat. Can't catch the four of you.
Who's Kozel?
By God. Kozel is the head of PRS.
Oh.
Does that mean Kozel has our friend?
They took one of our friends, which is why, I mean...
A friend.
They took more than that. Have you ever heard of X? The hacker?
Octavio.
Yes.
We've dealt with him before.
Sorry, Cross, go ahead.
I was gonna say, they took him. They took another one of us. Miss Eves. She's a prosecutor in LA region.
And her small beast.
Petunia.
Dog.
And a dog.
And a woman.
Yes.
And the four of you.
Yes.
How can I help?
Well, this is turned out. Are you surprisingly pleasant?
Well, yes, it is quite a surprise. You broke into my house. You could have knocked on the... I'm guessing
You've been
the kitchen...
chased for the past
Why?
Week. Everyone wants to kill us.
Why is my doggy door...
You don't want to know. Aware?
Busted. And why is there... Never mind, let's see now. This is glorious.
Do you have any more of that scotch?
Oh, yeah. So... You know, you guys are all in the living room, drinking scotch with Galushi, who has now kind of gotten up and handed a rag.
I'd like to say that I am drinking it inappropriately fast for scotch.
So you've got the bottle, and the rest of you have scotch glasses. Erid is still kind of not
I'm not sure yet.
Yeah, not sure
yet. I'm actually not drinking mine. I'm watching him, because last time he talked to a friend.
The man has a point.
I got shot in the shoulder. I'm just saying. I'm being polite, but I'm not actually doing much drinking. I'm mostly just watching.
Okay.
So I'm drinking.
You all lost a friend. And you want to get her back.
Yes.
All right.
And also, I mean, we're trying to solve a mystery of sorts of what happened to the four of them. They all have connections, we think, with the hospital that was in Idaho. I was researching it. I don't know if you remember that about me, but I like reading, and...
I don't care.
Okay. I was researching it. They all seem to be connected to that hospital. And we're not really... There was a 6-month period of their life that they can't remember.
I'll make you a deal. I'll help you find your friend. If, and only if, you agree that if you find Kozel, you murder the bastard.
What?
Yes.
Yes.
What?
We've got ourselves a deal.
No, wait a minute.
He kind of reaches around and he shakes Livia's hand and then he's like, he grabs your right hand and shakes
excitedly, I just give him my right hand. Huzzah.
Dear boy, my handiwork.
No.
Your handiwork?
Your handiwork?
Recognize this technology from a mile away.
You did this to me?
No, of course not. It's my design.
I'm gonna gently put a hand on. Calm down.
Look, you made the bugs? Do you know what
the
bugs. Do you know how they speak?
Dear God, this one is really stupid. Now.
I'm starting to feel a little bit insulted.
Now, I'll help you find your friend. I'm gonna help you though. Somehow you've evaded causal. I'm guessing that, like this one here with the rest of you being able to get away, have some advantages in combat. Would I be mistaken?
You're in a good ballpark.
Yeah. Be about the only way I could see you manage. But I can help. He picks up the phone. And dials kind of a number. Hello, John. Yeah, no, I know. It's the other John.
Yes. No, I'm good, thank you. No, all good. Yes. Question. No, yes, I know. It's a long time, yes. Tell me. Was there a transport recently? Yes. A woman and a dog. Very strange. Okay. Very well, thank you. Alright. Yeah, I know where your friend is.
Where is she?
California. Northeast. There's a facility outside Lake Tahoe. It's a holding cell. She was transferred there yesterday.
So she's still alive?
Apparently.
Why, do you know why they want her?
I didn't. You heard my conversation.
I know, but he might have mentioned, or maybe you would know why.
It was a quick conversation.
But why would PR? Why would anybody kidnap somebody like that?
You really know nothing about what your father did. Look, if she's anything like you, or him, I don't know what you all do, but I'm gonna need to know. PRS has valuable stock in people like you. Valuable resources. All of you. The type of people that win wars. That's what they do. That's what we did.
So we're just weapons, commodities.
Yes.
They meant to use us?
Not really meant, they did.
They did.
Do you know?
But
do you know anything about that facility then?
What
facility? The hospital.
What hospital?
In Idaho.
In Idaho.
There's.
Remember the explosion about 5 days ago?
On the news.
Yes.
Erida has footage of us and our friend that they took at that hospital.
No, nothing.
What about the pictures?
What?
Pictures on the magic box. We're all wearing white clothing that I've never worn before, and I don't think I've seen you wearing before. We don't remember them. When were they taken?
I don't know.
Were you still in active service 2 years ago?
No.
Maybe it's something new. Maybe it was a new initiative. Like, how long do those things take?
What things? Initiatives?
Yeah.
I don't know. Kozel's in charge. He could have changed lots of things.
That's another black box, but you can...
I wouldn't put it above them. We took people like you, but not like you all. You all are very strange. Not the kind of people that PRS would usually find themselves mixed up in.
Why is it?
Well, you. Your father was a good man, but... Wait. Your picture wasn't on the news.
No.
Why are you... You aren't a part of whatever they were you?
No. But I was there when
at the hospital in Idaho when the explosion happened.
Interesting. You know what? We'll dive into what you can and can't do in a little bit. How you got here, I don't care. But I will say this. PRS doesn't invest in... Well, you're not good investments, let's put it that way. You have no training. You're nobodies. You're a caveman. I don't know what you two are, but you're obviously not of any sort of military training.
That's the nicest thing anyone's ever said to me today.
Cheers. So, we're gonna do this. We're gonna get your friend back. I will help you in the field as your commander. We're gonna do this the old-fashioned way. You're obviously very untrained, but of reasonable power to get where you are now, so tap into that. Wouldn't be my first team that I've led into battle. It's a small group out there, probably 10, maybe 12 lower level PRS agents, which you seem to have avoided so far. Have you had any run-ins with some of the higher level agents?
There was one. What was his name? Fish? Deep Fish?
Right, yeah. Fish?
Reaper Fish.
Reaper Fish.
Reaper Fish.
Yes.
There was one Reaper Fish.
Okay.
It threw a strange device that hurt two of us.
That's important. Psyop bomb. Who did it affect?
You. Cross and Arida.
Ah. It's all starting to make sense now.
Didn't know. Mm.
Oh.
Your father.
Mm-hmm.
Father of the Psyop.
Yeah.
I see now why your last years were rough on you, huh?
They were a little tough. A little bit of an understatement, but yeah.
Your father, he saw a lot of things in his line of work. A lot of people, like you, do terrible things.
A lot of people like you do terrible things.
No arguing that. Now, I have a helicopter I've been wanting to use. Military grade.
How much money do you have?
Are we gonna ride in a helicopter?
Oh, most certainly.
Yes!
But I'm staying here. I will watch over you over satellite. Guide you along your way. Outfit you with military vests, cameras. I will keep track of you using infrared and drones.
You're trusting us with the helicopter.
Oh, you're not flying it. I have a pilot.
Thank God.
No. Must we do exactly as I say. If you do that, we'll rescue your friend.
Are we leaving immediately? Do I have time for some answers about whatever this is?
You're too stupid to understand anything I might tell you.
You could explain it to
me. I'm sorry, but that is the blunt truth.
But I need to know.
You were designed.
I was designed. By who?
I don't know. I know the technology, but the work? It's not PRS. It's sloppy. And it's unfinished. Tell me, do they speak to you?
Do they?
Yes, you're bugs. You're bugs.
Yes, sometimes. Not in a manner I understand.
You don't understand them. Yeah. Unfinished.
I will find out who did this to me.
So, PRS didn't do this to us.
I don't think so.
Then why are they after us?
I don't know. But they definitely didn't create you.
PRS, too sloppy. If PRS didn't make us, then we have more places to find answers, but we still need to find Lady Eves.
Eves first, and then maybe Chicago?
Yes. And then answers.
Rhea first.
Okay. Well, it's about an 8-hour flight on the helicopter. One catch. When you get there, either you find a place to fill it up, or you're on your own. you want a way back, you're gonna find a way to fuel it. You got enough and one tank to get there, not enough to come back. I'm not gonna provide you with weapons.
Could I trouble you for any meat?
Of course.
Thank you.
Yes, there's a meat fridge downstairs.
Wonderful! Yeah. I don't even hesitate. I've had lots of wild scotch. Boar. I'm going to town on that meat fridge.
All sorts of illegal meats from around the world.
You
about it.
All right.
I'm guessing they hunger sometimes.
Yeah.
They do.
Gosh.
So excited that somebody understands me.
Well, wait till they start eating people and then come back and talk to me.
What?
So, are you all ready?
Can we go back to the killing part?
Nope. I'm getting bored with you.
Already in the hand.
So, the vagabonds, our vanquished vagabonds, clean up and start preparing themselves.
Can I actually get the spots off of my head and beard and actually get clean shaven?
We'll allow Cross to get a clean shave while they wait for the helicopter to get fueled up and ready to go and for the pilot to arrive. And we'll have to check back in next week. I'm vanquished for the helicopter ride.
To
Eves!
To
hashtag save Petunia!
Save Petunia!
Hashtag save Petunia.
No love for Axe at all.
We can save Axe too.
Oh yeah, that's right. Axe is pretty kidnapped.
Pretty kidnapped.
Pretty kidnapped.
He is pretty kidnapped. Hey, I didn't get anything on me this time.
You didn't! That's
not
good.
Too late.
Woo! Yeah! And we didn't kill anybody! Yay!
Yeah.
No, is this villains. The first episode we haven't killed someone yet?
Was this... You didn't kill anyone this
and
episode.
And I didn't get anything on me. And I didn't puke. And I didn't faint. This was a successful...
Oh, but we did find out you're married to Nebraska. That's... Yeah. It's a big development.
We shall forget.
Guys, thank you so much for tuning in to Vanquished on Hyper RPG. Thank you guys so much. We really appreciate you guys watching. We're going to read over the donations just so we can properly thank everyone that contributed to the show. And I have a question. Did we reach 500?
We did.
Oh! Now, this is exciting because Galushi, like, oh my God, there's a dog here.
Hi, Jude.
Galushi, now, like, Myrick is still in the game. You guys didn't kill him.
Yeah. Yay!
It's amazing how when you don't kill someone, things can, like, maybe turn around in your favor.
We're trying it out.
Talk like a Scottish person.
I also love that, yeah, that's gonna be great.
Best Sean Connery ever.
I'm still meeting people by attacking them. That's still my greeting of choice.
You guys still make everything 100 times harder than it should be. Try setting you guys up for easy outs and it's like, oh, come on!
I feel like my idea to put the car in neutral and push it down was solid.
Pushing a car in neutral down a mountain in the snow? Are you kidding me?
I thought the sled was a good call because you can't just sled in a car.
You're just talking on a cell phone for like three different phone calls and nobody thought, let's just call the tow truck. All right, guys, we have to do a giveaway for the next NPC. That's exciting. Now, guys, Rosalyn was going to try to make it tonight. I'm guessing her shoot got held up.
Being all professional.
Such a big shot these days.
I know, too cool for us.
Yep, she was stuck there till 10. Her shoot went overtime. But we will be off next week for 4th of July, but back with a full cast the week after and a exciting mission. And a helicopter ride.
Helicopter
ride. Oh gosh, I hope you guys make it to the location.
Oh, shit. Oh my god.
He just gave us Kevlar vests and no weapons.
Isn't that why we have a pilot?
We have weapons. We are the weapons.
You guys are the weapons. That is true. And you will be coached by Sean Connery along the way.
How does that ghost feel about flying?
Save Eves and Petunia. So, let's do that giveaway. You doing that giveaway? Guys, be active in the chat. This is the NPC giveaway. And then after the NPC giveaway, we're going to do a Valiant rulebook and expansion giveaway, and a couple comics,
and big ol' Harbinger.
And Harbinger Volume 1, which is friggin' amazing. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Hopefully you're still liking the show. Make sure and share it with your friends. We can't wait to get back to a full cast for you guys. There's all sorts of stuff going on here.
We got a winner.
Who's our first winner?
Metus Phantom.
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 Fatum. Yeah, no. Oh, Mentus Fatum.
Just another easy
Mentus
name.
Mentus Fatum is our next NPC giveaway. Oh. You know, I'm just glad we still haven't got to somebody with numbers in their name yet. Oh my god, when we have to get to like somebody with numbers like Wilder, 1251.
It'd be a clone.
We had Geek 40, right?
We did have Geek 40.
We did have Geek 40. But luckily that one's kind of like...
It was spelled out.
I'm looking forward to Final Fantasy IX winning.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, that's going to be great.
It's going to be
great. Great. So congratulations on that win. You will be in next week's show. Who's our next winner of this wonderful comic book package that we're going to make all you guys sign?
Cool.
How do I get active in the chat while I'm here so I can win those things?
Because
I want all those books.
Well, you know that Twitch does have an app on your cell phone.
I don't have my phone with me on camera.
Oh, you know what? I'm going to throw in Dr. Morales.
Oh, no! Oh, no!
It's so good.
Someone's getting
it. I love this fucking book so much.
Our next winner is Eternal Knight 001.
Whoa! Eternal Knight! Congratulations! Congratulations, Eternal Knight. You win all of this wonderful stuff. Now I'm gonna go ahead and hand this over to the cast so they can start signing it and here's a Sharpie, while I read out the donations that we got during the show.
Hey, are we gonna do event points?
What's that?
Event points?
Ooh, we gotta vote for event points.
Vote for event points.
Okay.
I'm putting it on the white page because this is too pretty of a book to mess up.
It is a really pretty book. It is a real pretty book. Okay, guys, open up the votes for the event points. We've got number one with Cross, number two with Livia, number three with Nebraska, and number four with Arida. And I will announce my winner after they announce theirs. All right, so let's go through these donations and show some mad respect for everybody that contributed tonight. Thank you guys so much for being a part of the show. We really appreciate it. Like I said, hopefully you guys are still liking the show. Make sure and let us know on Twitter. Talk to us in Discord. I know we usually like to join Discord afterwards and talk to you guys. I had a lot of fun tonight. Did you guys have fun?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It was fun. You didn't kill anyone.
I
was worried because we didn't have any, like, I was like, I don't think you guys are going to reach combat today. And then there were a couple times where I was like, oh, shit, this could lead to combat. And then it didn't, but it was kind of nice. Like...
Actually, I was kind of scared when we were in the bed and breakfast because I was afraid they were not right.
I was so afraid I was going to eat Fluffy.
I really wanted to get to Galushi because, and that's the thing, when we start promising NPCs, it's like, oh shit. Because it's like, we could go that way, but I didn't even know you guys were going to stop at a bed and breakfast, so it's like, fuck. There's lots of people that keep showing up in these where you guys are like, I'm going to go do this thing. And it's like, oh fuck. God damn it.
I just can't believe he wants to lead us. Like, he must be really bored. That's all I can think of.
He's really bored, and nothing would make him feel better than making Kozel look like an idiot.
Kozel, he hates
Kozel. All right, White Wabbit. We remember what he said. And then we had William TW with the $12, a little plotting across the board. DTD Merrick. You guys remember Merrick?
Hey, Merrick.
Yay, our favorite.
Hashtag lead narrator for the Revenge of the Nub.
Please don't let that be your supervillain name.
Deathstrike 44, $5. Aaron Kirby, we'll miss you. Hashtag moist, screw you goobs. That one might have come in late. Let's see. Oh, that was right before, actually. That one got backwards in the thing. Eternal Knight 001, $10. This one's for AJ and Liz. Love you guys. Aww. Less than three. Hashtag cross, hashtag Livia, hashtag whooshing. Gwitherin, $6. Is Zach actually growing a heart? What the fuck? Hashtag cross. At what point in the story was that? 6:16 p.m. Still talking to Grandpa before he started calling everyone an idiot.
Are we signing everything or just the red book?
You can sign both RPG books.
Oh, okay.
Just the RPG books, though.
Okay. Yeah, these are too pretty.
We don't want to soil the comic books with our names. No.
I refuse to write on a comic book. I don't care what people expect.
It would be sacrilegious.
Oh, you got one?
This one.
DTD Merrick, $21. Hashtag lead narrator, hashtag Ares, finish the plot point. Finish that plot point. Supalot, $125. Thank you so much, Supalot.
Wow, thank you.
You all have been doing a great job. Appreciate all the work you put in. Hashtag cross, hashtag Livia, hashtag Nebraska, hashtag Arida, hashtag lead narrator, hashtag whooshing.
All right, and then one more round.
Geica, $40. Hashtag Neonet would like to help both cross and lead narrator because we love chaos. Celador, $36. Hashtag Neonet donates to help Livia get a plot point. Alarida.
Oh my god, is that the ship name?
There's already a name!
Oh.
It's not a real ship until there's fanfic of it.
You know
saying.
That I was gonna give you a ton of shit when you said all the Scottish, like, really thick Scottish accent. I was like, oh, you're fucked.
That's what happens.
Oh, yeah.
Here's some help. Alarda, here's some help for Cross, Livia, Nebraska, and Arida. None of that Screech Lord, though. Let's see. Eridance, $6. Outstanding job so far tonight. Especially Arida, Cross, and Nebraska. Always so entertaining. Hashtag Wooshy.
Everybody but me?
Oh.
That's what you get for playing with the dog.
Working class hero, $37 for Arida so she can resist Nebraska's irresistible charm and good looks.
He's a handsome man.
William T.W., $12. Neonet loves Grandpa's plot. Pure Overlord candy. Cross and Livia. And lead narrator. Let's see. Negiyama, $30. Seder Krupp wants to kick in towards lead narrator. Lab Bugs, $42. Lead narrator needs a plot point. You guys are fantastic. Oh, thank you. White Wabbit, $15. Is this enough for a plot point? At one point, guys, when you were on the side of the road, I was typing in the chat room, please, someone give me a plot point. I was like, I need them to get through this. It was out of plot points. I was like, I could just make a tow truck show up. I could just make a tow truck show up.
Signed live on air.
Rabbit Wombat, $442, $50. Renraku thinks lead narrator needs some help because this is going to be fun. Void Smoker, $50. Horizon thinks that Arida just might be the one to save the group again. 8:19 p.m. was Lumiere, $49. Shiwase is joining Zach's trolling somehow and wishes him to have another plot point, lead narrator. Arkansas donated $9. In Arkansas textbooks, Colorado is part of Canada. By our standard, Zach's accent work is spot on. Points across. Hey, look, Canadians moved to Colorado. They can't all be cookie cutters. Let's see. Gaika, $25. Neonet donates $2 for lead narrator, $22 for Cross. Not sure if the program will allow you to do that, but nice try. Navier, $5. Lead narrator for every day you want to leave. Hashtag Aries. And that was it for tonight. Guys, thank you so much for your donations. So much for getting us to that $500 for the NPC giveaway. You guys, it means a lot. Please connect with our hosts on Twitter. Talk to these guys. Thank you, Joe, for the stereotypical music tonight. Very much appreciated. Dead on with the sound effects.
Always.
Do you know Scottish people just wear kilts and listen to bagpipes?
All the time.
And drink scotch, yeah.
Man, I wish we could vote for Joe for event point, because I think that was the best that moment of tonight was Joe's sound effect.
The Betty Hill.
The Betty Hill.
Oh, yeah, now we have our own theme music.
Yeah, good job, Joe. Good job.
Apparently a name. You kept saying vagabonds a whole lot.
Yeah. You guys are definitely a group of vagabonds, that's for sure.
I like it. The value to vagabonds.
Yep. So, guys, thank you so much. That was Tuesday night. Monday night. Oh, my God. What?
Event points?
What was the vote?
What was the vote?
Did you guys make a vote? I didn't see people voting. Oh, they did. Let me... It looks like Arida wins the event point.
Thank you.
And I'm going to give mine to Livia for that I'm black comment. That was probably one of my favorite moments of the night. That was awesome.
I just love screwing with bigoted people. What can I say?
I like giving you bigoted people to screw with.
Thank you.
What happens when you grow up in the middle of the country and you have to represent them is like, fuck y'all. I'm going to make you look bad. All right, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you had some fun. So, that's it. I think that's the end of Monday Night Programming. So,
all right.
Goodbye, everybody.
Bye. Tomorrow
morning with Starmazer. What's up?
We got a raid.
Oh, we got a raid.
Let's raid.
Sure, why not?
Should we go raid number one Alex?
You want to raid number one Alex?
Yeah, let's raid number one Alex.
All right. Guys, we're going to raid number one Alex.
He's playing Link's Awakening for the first time.
Whoa!
That's a classic. It was a dream the whole time. Literally.
I've never played.
You have? That's one of the best Zelda games ever.
I've never played a Zelda game except for
Hyrule. Alienator saying that they named the team.
What'd you guys name us?
What did they name the team? He's like, we named the team, but what's the name?
Well, it's actually, that won't work because Vagabond is the name of one of the hardcore members.
It's true.
Oh, you're right. I don't mean we could be the Vagabonds, but you're right.
But it would only work if he was the leader, the Vagabond and the Vagabonds.
Oh, that'd be awesome. I'd be down for Vagabond show. I love that guy.
All right, raid command in chat.
All right.
Now he's naming them the Scots Men.
I like the name.
I don't. You're going on one mission with the dude. It's not sticking.
I would say he actually becomes our commander and he's the leader of us.
Lord.
I mean, right, anything guys. Is possible, but that would suck.
Your accent would get real good.
Yeah. You'd get real good at that Connery by a few months.
Your Connery was not
You have
bad.
To get a kilt.
Yeah.
I thought it was pretty good.
We can arrange that. We live in the Pacific Northwest.
Guys, no. Stick around for a raid. Don't leave. These raids help us a lot. When you guys are on your best behavior on these raids, it really does bring a lot of new followers and new eyes to what we're doing. Given that we are a new channel with very little reach, those kinds of things go a really long way to help the channel out. So please do join in on the raid. Number One Alex is a great guy, and you're really gonna enjoy his stream. He's a lot of fun. So go over there, make some friends, say hello, and it's a great way for them to then see we're awesome and come over and hang with us. So please do it, guys. Are you ready?
Ready?
I'm ready.
Are you ready to raid, dude?
I'm so ready.
You ready to raid? I think Rai is ready to raid, guys.
It's our 3-month anniversary.
Rai the raid guy.
In 3, 2, 1. Go!
Raid.
And then host.
Host.
Thank you guys again so much. I'm gonna keep talking until the host happens. That way, if people are still watching, and even when they host, we usually, like, some people just click through and watch us be awkward for a little bit, but Joe's on the board tonight, so we'll be good. You got that host, dog?
Let me make sure.
My hand's getting tired.
One second.
I drank a lot of water. No.